They said there's a town in the United States that makes him look like he's a Sunday school teacher. I got to reading the story. This town has 500 people in the town, Austin. 500.
So it must be out west somewhere, right?
One cop for every 50 people in the town.
Okay.
10 cops for a town that has 500 people that literally stretches for about 1,260 feet on a major U.S. highway.
How is that considered?
That's less than a quarter of a mile.
Yeah, how is that considered a town? How come surrounding
they have a town? They have a mayor, everything. They're a town. Incorporated.
Something to be proud of, I guess.
Between 2011 and 2012, they wrote 12,698 tickets.
Wow.
On a 1,260-foot stretch of highway. It resulted in hundreds and hundreds of thousands of dollars in fines.
So basically, that's their lifeline.
That is. People that live in this town say, we ain't getting none of that money.
Right.
Auditors went in, so showed that were any people in the town, maybe living the lavish lifestyle, you know, the mayor or city councilman or the chief of police or something? Nope. The city clerk got overpaid $9,000 one year. But that's really, that's what, a little less than $900 a month she overpaid herself.
Right.
There was a ongoing a charge account at the BP service station next door to City Hall to the tune of $132,000.
Okay.
It was a charge account for, gas and food and everything. They also failed to insure any of the city police cars and didn't have any accurate track of where the money went that they got from all these tickets they had written.
Sounds a little fuzzy.
It does sound a little fuzzy. It's like something out of a Southern Gothic novel, State Senator Rob Bradley said. The town exists apparently just to write speeding tickets. Most people don't understand why it exists in the first place. Literally, the cops have been seen sitting on lawn chairs, pointing radar guns at motorists, hiding behind recycling bins, and as more and more money came in, they idled in slick SUVs, trolled the median strips in riot gear, and toted state-of-the-art firepower. Locals in the area gave one cop the nickname Rambo because he would sit out there with his radar gun and an AR-15 across his chest.
So you're telling me this town of how many?
500.
500 had police force with riot gear
and AR-15s. And slick, tricked out SUVs.
Wow.
The mayor of this town was recently accused of selling oxycodone to undercover police officers.
We still have yet to identify what this town is or where this town is.
Another former mayor said he played a role in greasing the revenue pipeline for the speed trap, but he thought the money would go back into the town. The local sheriff in the county this town is located in said it's cash register justice. The police there serve and collect, not serve and protect. He said officials made the over-the-top corrupt suit-wearing boss hog from the popular Dukes of Hazzard TV show look like a Sunday school teacher. So what happens now? Well, the town's got a month to come up with a reason why it's a town, to show that it's a viable town.
Or else surrounding towns, I'm assuming, will take
over. No, or the county will take it over and it'll just become, part of the county.
Okay.
My friend called me and told me I had to look at this story. And I said, okay. So I looked at this story. Now, the reason that I had to look at this story is where this town is located.
Must be from Georgia, right near.
Now, Statesboro. I've lived in places in Georgia near Statesboro.
Yes.
I've lived in Atlanta. Lived in the mountains of North Carolina. Lived in Chicago. I've lived in quite a few places. Pine Mountain, Georgia, in the city of Atlanta, is a one-mile town that's a speed trap. This isn't Pine Mountain, Georgia. It's only 1,260 feet. But anyone who lives in this area we live in here, if you ever traveled up Highway 301 going towards Jacksonville, you have driven through what CNN and the state of Florida legislature is calling the most corrupt town in America, Hampton, Florida.
Hampton, Florida.
It's 1,260 feet. Literally all that's in Hampton is a BP gas station where two roads come together, another gas station up on 301, and 301's the highway they're doing all this stuff on.
Yes.
I know the cop. I don't know him, but I knew the cop that they referred to as Rambo because I would see him. I used to live in Hawthorne. Hawthorne and Hampton. You got on 301, you got Hawthorne, then you got Waldo, then you got Hampton. Then you got Stark. This is in between Waldo and Stark on 301.
Right, and I know that on that road and that stretch of area, there's signs that say...
No, those signs are for Waldo and for Lottie. Hampton is not part of those signs.
Okay.
No. I know exactly what you're talking about. No.
The signs say something to the effect of slow down.
Slow down, speed trap 2.25 miles ahead.
Yeah.
Yeah, those are for Lottie, which is on the north side of Stark, and for Waldo, which is on the south side of Stark. Matter of fact, if you're going to the Gator Nationals this weekend, I am, thank you. The best way to get there is to go through Waldo and cut across to get to the Gainesville Raceway, not to go through Gainesville, because the traffic will be terrible. But Waldo and Lottie, you've always been told to watch out for. Hampton, about 10 years ago, decided they wanted to get a piece of the action.
Well, now you know to not speed through Hampton. Maybe you can
there say, may not be a Hampton in another month.
Maybe you can wave high to Rambo as you drive through Saturday.
AR-15s.
And a riot shield.
Sitting in lawn chairs.
Something just doesn't add up.
$132,000 charge account at a convenience store. You know how many Red Bulls you got to drink at a convenience store to get $132,000?
It would be hard to spend $100,000.
You know how many Butterfingers and cans of Chef Boyardee, like ravioli, you got to eat at a convenience store? Because what else would you buy at a convenience store? Gas?
Alcoholic beverages.
Oh, yeah, see. If the mayor's accused of selling oxycodone, he may be a drink or two. You don't know.
Yes.
So beware, folks. Hampton, Florida. According to CNN and a few state legislatures, you know, the Bradford County Sheriff Gordon Smith told CNN it's a speed trap. Like I said, state Senator Rob Bradley from Bradford County says it's speed trap. So slow down going through 301. Don't be part of the reason that they're able to charge money at the BP. We're going to take a break. It's Tripping In Tuesday with Tom. When we come back, we'll get you started. Two tickets to Historic Marion Theater plus a $10 gift card to Mojo's Grill and Catering Company. Next, Tripping In Tuesday with Tom, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Since 1976, Daniel L. Hightower, a lawyer, has been fighting for accident victim justice in North Central Florida and statewide. He believes everyone in America should follow the rules, including the insurance companies. He and his firm have experience fighting for victims of personal injury, wrongful death, workers' compensation, and Social Security disability, as well as serving those in need of help with bankruptcy, simple wills, and estate plans. The mission at the law offices of Daniel L. Hightower, PA, is to represent deserving clients and recover the maximum benefits they are entitled to by law in a timely manner. In personal injury and workers' compensation cases, there are no fees or costs unless a recovery is made. The law office of Daniel L. Hightower is located at 7 East Silver Springs Boulevard, Suite 300. For your free consultation, call 352-629-7777 or 1-888-LAW-1976 and visit danhightower.com for more information. Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice, and the proud sponsor of Ask the Cops.
This reprise of Ask the Cops is proudly brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower.
PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
Chief Ray, I'd like to hear you and the sheriff to talk about how these cases come to you and how you find them out. And also, if you know of something and you're pretty sure something's going wrong, how to report it.
Yeah, you know, they come in all different kinds of ways. A lot of them come through the school system where teachers will notice behavioral changes in the kids. So they'll talk to them. Sometimes we'll get the reports from neighbors. Sometimes we get them from people in the community that see them at the mall and see the kids being abused out in the open, and they'll call us. So there's no really one way that we hear about it.
That was a reprise of Ask the Cops, proudly brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower, attorney fighting for accident victims justice since 1976, and can be heard the second and fourth Friday of every month on The Voice of Ocala.
Men, do you know your testosterone level? Are you experiencing decreased energy levels or unusual sleeping problems? Have you noticed you have less strength or endurance, decreased sex drive, increased irritability or depression? If so, you may be experiencing problems with low testosterone. If you're interested in a free testosterone screening, please call RenStar Medical Research at 352-629-5800. Again, that number is 352-629-5800.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Life jackets save lives. Where in Florida? Mostly sunny today and pleasantly warm. The high 79 on the coast, 85 inland. Increasing clouds tonight, though 60 to 64. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy and becoming breezy. With a couple of showers and a thunderstorm around, the high 80 to 84. Thursday, some clouds giving way to sunshine. Noticeably cooler, high 62 to 66. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Hi, this is Joe from Damage Control Services. Join me Tuesdays at 10:30 when we discuss what to do when your property gets damaged, how to fix it fast, and get back on track. At Damage Control, we specialize in helping home and business owners recover from damage caused by floods, fires, storms, tree damage, mold, and all other insurance-related disasters. So when disaster strikes, big or small, call Damage Control Services. Call me, 352-817-6574.
352-507-5352. 352-507-5352. 352-507-5352.
Tom.
352-507-5352.
Tom.
What?
What is that phone number?
Oh, that's our new number for the Voice of Ocala text line, 352-507-5352. If you want to reach Buddy, me, or any of y'all via text. So all you got to do is text 352-507-5352 anytime.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com. Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
WOCA. You're listening to Trivianator Tuesday with Tom Schmitz. He went to Georgia Southern. Don't ask.
And I just got broken. Broken into two. Still I call it magic.
We're back on a Tuesday afternoon for Trivianator Tuesday with Tom. Your chance to go up against me, the Trivianator, to win fantastic prizes. Today's first prize pack, two tickets to the historic Marion Theater, plus a $10 gift card to Mojo's Grill and Catering Company. All you have to do is answer two questions. If you get both of them right, you're the winner. First question is, my computer just shut down on me. Wonderful. It's always nice when that happens.
You and that computer have a great relationship.
We really do. What sport is the Ryder Cup associated with? It's a very easy question to get started with, Austin.
Yes.
What sport is the Ryder Cup associated with? If you know that answer, call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 for your chance to win two tickets to Historic Marion Theater plus a $10 gift card to Mojo's Grill and Catering Company. All you got to do is answer two questions, Austin, and you can win. They can win two tickets to Historic Marion Theater and a $10 gift card to the Mojo Grill and Catering Company. by calling the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622. For your chance to win, all you have to do is answer two questions. The first question is, what sport is associated with the Ryder Cup? Call in now on the Climate Control Source Hotline. So did you see this story yesterday out of Orlando, Austin? The father that was arrested in Daytona Beach for soliciting a prostitute.
Did not see that story.
Father of a three-year-old was allegedly pulled over and solicited a prostitute in a heavy area for that kind of activity in Daytona Beach.
Yes.
Was arrested for soliciting a prostitute while his three-year-old son was in the car with him. The three-year-old had to watch his father be arrested for solicitation, was taken in DCF custody and turned over to his mother later. The father made bail, says, a different story happened. I'll tell you what the father says after we get this caller. Who do we have?
David.
Hi, David. How are you today?
I am outstanding. What a beautiful day.
David, do you ever travel up 301 North headed towards Jacksonville?
I have.
Have you driven through the most corrupt city in America, according to CNN, Hampton, Florida?
And I slow way, way down every time I go through there.
You have to. And that's the guy. I've seen that guy they're talking about, Rambo, standing out on the side of the road with the AR-15 strapped across him, checking to see if you're speeding. So I know exactly. I've seen that guy they're talking about.
That's right. I honk at him and wave every time.
Yeah. It's a 45-mile-an-hour speed limit. You do 38.
Exactly.
All right, David. What sport is associated with the Ryder Cup?
That's golf.
That is golf. You answer the second question right, you'll win two tickets to Historic Marion Theater, plus a $10 gift card to Mojo's Grill and Catering Company. Who won Album of the Year Grammy in 1980 for his album 52nd Street?
Well, that'd be Billy Joel.
See how easy it is? People are just beating me up. David, you're a winner today. Stay on the line. Austin's going to get your information, tell you how to get your prizes.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for playing today. See, Austin, they're just whooping me. They're just beating me up. David, I got to change the harder questions, I think. I think that's what I got to do.
What's the first letter of your last name?
I got to change the harder questions. This is just getting too much. Buddy's not going to let me continue to do this if I keep giving away the store. And, I'm giving away the store, so I'm going to have to do something about this. Yep. All right. The next question for Trent Randy Tuesday with Tom. Neil Armstrong, the man who took me one giant leap from one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. Neil Armstrong was a pilot during what war? Neil Armstrong was a pilot during what war? If you know that answer, call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 for your chance to win. See what I give away now. Hey, I give away two rounds of golf to Ocala Golf Club. Give away two rounds of golf to Ocala Golf Club. Neil Armstrong was a pilot in which war? If you know that answer, call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 for your chance to win. Do we have a caller, Austin?
Johnny.
We have a caller. I believe we're going to Johnny. Johnny, hi. How are you today?
Good. How you doing?
Wonderful, Johnny. Have you ever taken a trip up 301 North through Hampton?
I sure have, very slowly.
Yeah. You know, the report came out that they're the most corrupt city in the United States, according to CNN, a report on CNN. They have a charge account at a BP in that city right next to the police station for $132,000.
That's donuts for sure.
That's a lot of raviolis and ramen noodles from that convenience store.
Yes.
All right, let's play Trivia Nation Tuesday with Tom. Neil Armstrong was a pilot in what war, Johnny?
Vietnam.
He was not a pilot in Vietnam. Ooh, that was a good guess, though. Thanks for playing Trivia Nation Tuesday with Tom.
Have a good day.
You as well. Neil Armstrong was a pilot during what war? If you know that answer, call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 for your chance to win two rounds of golf to Ocala Golf Club. Candace Clatterbaugh and her group out there at Ocala Golf Club do a great job. Muni's in great shape. Transition's coming in good, starting. It's going to be in great shape come time for the camp golf tournament. So Really looking forward to playing some golf out there, and I'm going to give you a chance to play golf out there. Two rounds of golf at the Ocala Golf Club. All you have to do is call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 for your chance to win. Austin, who do we have?
Sino.
Sino, how are you today?
Not too bad, brother. How are you doing?
Good. Have you taken that trip up 301 North through Hampton?
Just like the previous caller, very, very slowly.
Sometimes I think walking may get you a ticket.
Especially if you cross the street with a no walking sign, right?
Exactly. And you've driven through there. You know the SUVs we're talking about. They're state-of-the-art, brand-new SUVs for a town that has 500 people. They have 10 cops for one cop for every 50 people in town. It's ridiculous.
Well, it must be safe then, right?
Yeah, it must be very safe. No donut shops, though, so they're probably pretty good over there.
Maybe we should open one.
It's probably a very good point. All right, what war was Neil Armstrong a pilot in?
I'm gonna say the Korean War.
The Korean War is correct. Correct. Okay, if you get this second one right, you'll win two rounds of golf at Ocala Municipal Golf Club. Who followed Woodrow Wilson as president?
Oh my goodness. Jeez.
Who followed Woodrow Wilson as president?
Woodrow Wilson.
Five seconds.
I'm just going to go ahead and make a guess. I don't know. One of the Roosevelts.
The Roosevelts were not correct. Thanks, Sino.
You got me on that one.
Thanks, buddy, for playing today. All right. The question out there is, who followed Woodrow Wilson as president of the United States? If you know that answer, call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 for your chance to win two rounds of golf at the Ocala Golf Club. Muni to those of us that play golf on a regular basis. It's in great shape. Candace Clatterball, Chris Conley, the new pro out there, they're doing great things out there at Ocala Golf Club. Austin, do we have a caller?
No, we do not.
We do not have a caller. All right. So I was telling you this dad that got arrested for prostitution in Daytona. He says, I said, I didn't ask for it. I just was pulled over to pray for her. Ooh. I said, I want to pray for you. I got my kid with it. She said, that's cool. I got a room. I said, yeah, whatever. Then I turned around to get her away from my car. As soon as I drove away, blocks up the road, they lit me up and pulled me over. Now, the chief of police, Chipwood of Daytona, says he's a father, married man, normally on Ridgewood Avenue. They're disease-infested prostitutes. You run the risk to get robbed or whatever else you want to do, and you think it's okay to bring your four-year-old kid with you? Now, William says he wasn't doing anything shady with the woman. He believes she was a prostitute. And in fact, he said while on the way by to buy his kids toys, he stopped to pray for the woman.
I don't know about that.
I don't know. I mean, I understand if you're a religious man and you see people doing stuff of ill repute and you want to stop and pray with them, I understand that. I'm not real sure, even if that's what you were doing, though, you should do it with your 3 or 4 year old son in the vehicle with you, in an area where you know people could rob you. Just doesn't seem like smart to me. It's Trivinator Tuesday with Tom. The question on the floor right now is, who followed Woodrow Wilson as president of the United States? If you know that answer, call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 for your chance to win two rounds of golf at Ocala Municipal Golf Course. Austin, who do we have?
Oksana.
Oksana, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Wonderful. Do you travel much up 301 North headed to Jacksonville?
Yeah, I do it a lot.
And you know in Hampton you're supposed to slow down to a crawl too, don't you?
I will know it now.
Oksana, let's play Trivinator Tuesday with Tom. Who followed Woodrow Wilson as president of the United States?
Warren Garden.
Warren Harding. Yes, that's correct. All right, now, next question. If you answer this one, you'll win two rounds of golf at Ocala Golf Club, Muni, those of us who play. In what year were U.S. ground troops first dispatched to Vietnam? In what year were U.S. ground troops first dispatched to Vietnam? You got 5 seconds.
I'm not sure about that one.
Okay. You want to take a guess? 65 is correct. Correct. So hold on the line. We'll get your information. You're a winner. Hold on, Austin. I'll get your information.
Thank you.
Yep. Wow, Austin, she took a guess. They're killing me. They're taking all. I'm going to have to take a break. See, I got to collect myself. This is too much. I'm just giving away the store. I've already given away Marion Theater tickets, Mojo's Grill. Now I'm giving away two rounds of golf to Ocala Golf Club. I'm flabbergasted the way people are winning stuff. I just don't understand. People are just taking advantage of me. The Trivianator is not having a good week or so. Last week I got killed. Last week I got killed. This week I got killed. I'm just not having a good week. Maybe I'm gonna have to get harder questions.
1 second.
I thought those were pretty hard questions. I'm gonna take a break. I'm gonna regroup and come back with more Trivianator Tuesday with Tom after this on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, the new old-fashioned bank. Let us introduce you to Okus, a simple way to bring your business online. Through this relationship, your business can have a fully functioning website in less than 30 minutes. We will also provide you support with social media, sales tracking, e-commerce, and online scheduling, which is all optimized for mobile users. Okus, now at Gateway Bank, Silver Springs Boulevard, Ocala. Come visit our technology center for your total small business solution. I'm Tom Ingram, and I'll see you there.
Hi, I'm Buddy Martin, the host of The Voice of Ocala, every weekday from 3 to 6 right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM. A lot of people ask me, how do you keep a muzzle on Tom Schmitz? Forget about it.
This is Austin Tavern reminding you to stay in contact with us at WOCA. Find us on Twitter and Instagram at Voice of Ocala. Make sure to become a friend of our Facebook page and call us at 622-9622.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to pet expert Charlotte Reed and veterinarian Dr. Michael C. Fleck. They're calling in live from the Global Pet Expo at the Orange County Convention Center in Orlando.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Mark E. Becker will be with us. He's an attorney, and he wants to talk about why more and more people are not using the legal system and are going outside the law to resolve their issues.
Stay tuned for a new quarterly show called Higher Education Happenings with Mike Fallon, Dr. Jennifer Friend, Crystal Flynn, and Katie Degner, speaking about current higher education topics that impact Marion County students, parents, and the local economy.
And then tune in to Legally Yours. John Fuller is the host of that show. He's an attorney from here in Ocala, and he'll answer your legal questions.
Brandy Cooney and Julie Whitaker is from the Childhood Development Services. They'll be speaking about their fundraising event happening this Saturday, the tour around the world.
All of that plus Fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live, right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Did you know that Marion County has a vast equine business? Tune in every Friday at 9:30 for Horse Sense, when we connect, communicate, and educate you on ways to participate in and enjoy all the equine adventures this area has to offer.
Sponsored in part by Infinite Day Spa, Almara Arabian Horses, and Florida Thoroughbred Breeders Owners Association, FTBOA.
Fridays at 9:30, right here on The Source.
I'm a different breed.
Hi, Danny Werfel here. Get moving with Florida Credit Union's fast and easy loan approval process.
Let Florida Credit Union start up a new car loan for you today. No more waiting, hassles, or stop signs. You can even apply online. With a strong financial team behind you, you can enjoy great rates and fast approvals.
It's all about personalized service and a streamlined process.
Florida Credit Union, connecting your money to your life.
Hi, I'm Buddy Martin. Don't touch that dial. I'll be along in just a moment here after Tom and the Tribunator, right here on the Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, the source.
Hello? Can you hear me? Because if you can, then so can your customers. Radio works. Call today to advertise your business right here on WOCA 1370, the source.
This is Tom Schmitz live in the WOCA studios with this news break brought to you by Gateway Bank. For the fourth time in 2 months, Lockheed Martin has announced a new military contract that will result in work for its Ocala facility, which employs more than 900 people. $14 million contract with the U.S. Army was agreed upon in late 2013, but announced Monday. It involves the design and modernization of the Apache helicopter turret system. The Army can extend the contract an additional $24 million through 2015. The contract will produce enough work for the Ocala Lockheed Martin employees through 2017. This news update was brought to you by Gateway Bank, your new old-fashioned bank. Join Buddy Fridays for Community Gazette Day at Gateway Bank. She expected the world, but it flew away from her reach, and the bullets catching her teeth. Life goes on, it gets so heavy, the wheel breaks the butterfly. We're back on Tribunator Tuesday with Tom. I'm just getting shelled today, Austin.
No, you got to step your game up, man.
I do. Oksana was gracious enough, though she doesn't golf, so we were able to trade out the golf for a Mojo's gift card. So she gave the two rounds of golf back. So I'm going to try to give them away.
All right. It's a good prize.
Two rounds of golf at Ocala Golf Club, Ocala Municipal Golf, to those of us who play regularly at the course. It's out on East Silver Springs Boulevard, right across from the old Cody's that burnt down. But you know what a golf course is on Silver Spring Boulevard. Candace Clatterball and her staff out there do a really good job at Ocala Golf Club. So this is for two rounds of golf to the Ocala Golf Club. What was first published in a newspaper? What was published for the first time in a newspaper on December 21st, 1913? It was published in the New York World. What was first published on December 21st, 1913 in the newspaper for the first time? The newspaper was the New York World. What was first published for the first time ever in the New York World? It was published in that newspaper first, and it was done December 21st of 1913. If you know that answer, call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 for your chance to win two rounds of golf at Ocala Golf Club. I might have them this time, Austin.
That's a tough question.
I might have them this time. It's starting to aggravate me. People make me look bad. So, I know you've never been to prison, Austin. I know that.
How do you know that?
Well, I know that.
Correct. I've never.
But even if you did go to prison, I promise you won't be as dumb as this guy. Daniel Clegg, 34. From Arizona, serving time at the prison in Florence, Arizona, was released from prison on Thursday morning. Why is that important? I'll tell you right after we take this caller on Tribunator Tuesday with Tom. Who do we have, Austin?
Dan.
Hi, Dan. How you doing?
Good, Tom. How you doing?
I'm doing good. You don't go up through Hampton, do you, on 301 North when you're going up north, do you?
I take 301 North when I go up north all the time.
Yeah, well, you know where Waldo is. You slow down, correct?
Oh, I've seen people pull. I've said to my wife, that person's going too fast, they're going to get a ticket, and bam, they do.
In Waldo?
Yeah. And bam, they do.
And in Lodi, you don't get to slow down.
Yeah, no, very well.
But the most corrupt city in America, according to CNN, is Hampton, Florida. Just past Waldo, before you get to Stark.
I was surprised to read that.
It's a town of 500 people. What are you going to do, right?
I don't know.
All right, Dan, let's play Tribunator Tuesday with Tom. What was published for the first time in the New York World, December 21st, 1913?
A 15-letter word for crossword puzzle.
It was a crossword puzzle, first time ever. All right, if you know this next question, you're a winner of 2 rounds of golf at Ocala Municipal Golf Course.
Oh, make it a good one.
You a fan of Demi Moore?
Yeah, I always thought she was cute.
What soap opera did she get her start on?
That was, I believe, All My Children.
All My Children is not correct.
Oh,
dadgummit, Dan, you were that close.
I know which one it was. I had to pick one.
All right, Dan, have a good afternoon.
Thanks, bye-bye.
Yep. What soap opera did Demi Moore find her fame? If you know that answer, call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 for your chance to win 2 tickets, 2 rounds of golf at Ocala Municipal Golf Club. Ocala Golf Club, Muni, answers to all those names. So I was telling you about Daniel Clegg. Well, a canine deputy in Florence, Arizona, where the prison is located, pulled over a Lexus on Thursday morning after he saw the driver commit several traffic violations on I-10. The driver told the deputy he'd pick Clegg up, who was the passenger, a few hours earlier from the prison in Florence. The deputy noticed that Clegg's shirt was covered with marijuana flakes. He searched the car, found drugs under Clegg's seat, found a loaded gun with Clegg's paperwork in it. He was released from prison an hour and a half earlier and now is awaiting not only parole revocation, but charges for felony possession of a firearm by a convicted felon and drug charges.
Come on, man.
He'd been out 90 minutes.
Is that a record? I feel like it has to be a record.
What kind of idiot was this? These are exactly the people Greg Graham and Chris Blair, the chief police and the sheriff in our area, tell us about. Dumb criminals.
Yes.
He's out of prison an hour and a half, gets busted with pot all over him and a loaded gun.
Do you want to go back?
Do you want to go back?
Did you enjoy your stay in prison that you want to do something to go back?
Were those meals so good that you just knew?
The bed was so comfortable.
Mama don't cook the way they cooked in prison.
Doesn't make sense to me.
What kind of idiot are you? You know, usually that happens either in Ohio or Florida, but this was Arizona, so we got a little relief there.
At least for this story.
Let's go to the phone and see who we have.
CJ.
CJ, hi. How are you, buddy?
Tom, what's going on, buddy?
You think you can beat Tom today?
I'm going to try.
You have no shot, just so you know. Just so you know. All right, CJ, what soap opera did Demi Moore find fame on?
General Hospital.
General Hospital. That is correct, sir. Now, if you get this second question right, you'll win 2 rounds of golf to Ocala Municipal Golf Club. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Let me see where. Oh, there it is, right there. Static? No. Who wrote The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxies?
Oh, I have no idea. Let's go. I have no idea.
CJ, you hate me, don't you?
Maybe next week.
All right, CJ, have a good day. Who wrote The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy? Very good book. One of my favorite books. That's why it made this question. People are like, who would know that? I know it. Why wouldn't you? It's one of my favorite books.
I have no idea.
You've heard of the book, though, haven't you?
Yes, yeah. I have no idea who wrote it.
Well, see, you should pay attention. Who wrote The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxies? If you know that, call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622 for your chance to win 2 rounds of golf at Ocala Golf Club. We're telling about this idiot that got arrested an hour and a half after he got out of prison, charged with possession of drugs, and possession of a firearm by a felon.
Yeah, he thought the bed was more comfortable than his bed at home, so he wanted to go back.
So, you thought he was kind of dumb. Well, let me tell you about this guy in the Atlanta area. Ryan Jones, he was shot Sunday afternoon around 4:30 outside a house in Canton, Georgia.
Who's this?
Witnesses told the sheriff he showed up demanding that the owner of the home pay him a debt he said the owner owed him. He was shot by the owner of the home, and the owner of the home now is not going to be charged because he was defending his home as Ryan Jones showed up with a gun. Loaded gun. So the owner shot him with a shotgun. Only problem is Ryan Jones showed up with a loaded BB gun.
Oh, my gosh.
Give me my money or else. Or else what?
Or else, how about you're not intimidating me?
Yeah. I'm going to shoot you in the eye. It's like the Red Rider BB. I could put your eye out. Yeah, I have a shotgun. I could take your life.
I give you a little welt on your leg.
This idiot shows up. You give me my money, or I'll shoot you with my BB gun. You get away from my front porch, or I'm going to shoot you with my shotgun. How about that?
Yeah.
And he shot him with the shotgun. Another moron going with a gun, thinking he's going to pull something off. Who do we have on the line, Austin?
Hugh.
Hugh, hi. How are you, Hugh?
Pretty good. You guys are having too much fun today. And I got hit by a BB gun one time, and this thing stings.
Yeah, Hugh, or buckshot out of a shotgun. Which would you rather be shot with?
Well, I'd probably the BB gun.
Yeah, I thought you'd see my way of thinking there, Hugh.
Yeah.
All right, Hugh, let's play Trivia Day Tuesday with Tom. The question is, who wrote Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy?
Well, that's a wild guess. I'd say Carl Sagan.
Carl Sagan is not correct, Hugh.
Yeah, he died quite a few years ago, so I think this is a more recent book, right?
Yeah, well, it's an older book. It's probably, older, you know, book, 30 yeah. years old.
See, I'm going to tell you real quick. I told my sister-in-law who lives in Jacksonville, when you go up 301, be careful. Sure enough, she got a ticket in Waldo.
In Waldo. I know. You got to watch it. You got to watch it.
Yeah, that was after warning her. I told her, I said, be very, very careful. There's three spots that are bad. I almost got stopped in Waldo one time. I just a warning ticket because I was only like 2 miles over the speed limit.
Right.
I even stopped for that. But I told her, I said, watch what you're doing. And sure enough, she got a ticket on the way home.
Well, there you go. See, it's just good warning, and then they don't listen to you, Hugh.
Okay, take care, you guys.
All right, Hugh, thanks. Who wrote Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy? I'll give you that answer after the break. 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life. From everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on.
Men, do you know your testosterone level? Are you experiencing decreased energy levels or unusual sleeping problems? Have you noticed you have less strength or endurance, decreased sex drive, increased irritability or depression? If so, you may be experiencing problems with low testosterone. If you're interested in a free testosterone screening, please call Renstar Medical Research at 352-629-5800. Again, that number is 352-629-5800.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, the new old-fashioned bank. Let us introduce you to Okus, a simple way to bring your business online. Through this relationship, your business can have a fully functioning website in less than 30 minutes. We will also provide you support with social media, sales tracking, e-commerce, and online scheduling, which is all optimized for mobile users. Okus, now at Gateway Bank, Silver Springs Boulevard, Ocala. Come visit our technology center for your total small business solution. I'm Tom Ingram, and I'll see you there.
WOCA. Hi, I'm Yvette, and I'm here to tell you a few things about ABC Frederick's Appliance. They sell not only new, but used guaranteed appliances. When you call ABC Frederick's Appliance, they will provide service on what they sell and any appliances that you own. ABC Frederick's Appliance is located in Bellevue, right over the railroad tracks. Call 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. That's 352-629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance.
Hi, this is Jody Saulnier. Jeff and I are the owners of J&J Jewelers in the Jasmine Plaza, which is located at the intersection of State Road 200 and Airport Road.
With Third Generation Jewelers, voted Ocala's favorite jewelry store for the last 5 years.
We carry a wide selection of new and estate jewelry, bridal sets, and citizen watches. J&J Jewelers specialize in jewelry repair and custom design jewelry, including wedding sets.
All of our repairs are done on site and can even be done by appointment while you wait. J&J Jewelers is open Tuesday through Friday, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m., Saturday, 10 to 2, and closed on Sunday and Monday.
Stop by today or visit our website at jandjjewelersocala.com or call 352-401-0001. You'll remember our custom design made for you by us at J&J Jewelers. Proud to be made in America.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
People who do the most texting at night have the worst sleep. Because each time we send a text, a part of our brain goes on high alert because we're waiting for a response. Frequent use of artificial sweeteners has been shown to increase hunger and to lead to weight gain. Couples who laugh together are the happiest because laughter makes us secrete feel-good endorphins. So laughter usually means long-term love.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Hi, I'm Buddy Martin. Don't touch that dial. I'll be along in just a moment here after Tom and the Tribunator, right here on the Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, the source.
We're back on the Voice of Ocala Tribunator Tuesday with Tom. The question was, who wrote Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy? The correct answer, Douglas Adams. Douglas Adams was the answer to that question. I got a text from Buddy Martin. Not going to be able to get a paycheck this week. I've given too much stuff away. He's going to have to use it to buy prizes.
Tribunator.
That's not good.
Not for you.
No, that's not good for me at all. For the listening audience, I think that's great. But yeah, for me?
Listening audience, definitely beat up on the Tribunator.
We should probably take up a collection for the Tribunator from the listening audience now. Of course, I've so browbeat them about how unintelligent they are. It's just a little bit of payback. They're not going to give me anything.
Right.
Well, Buddy always said, you keep burning them bridges, and they're going to come back to get you, and then nobody's going to feel sorry for you.
That's what happened.
This may be one of those times.
Yeah.
Speaking of Buddy Martin, he joins us in the next hour. And Angie Lewis will be in here to brighten up the studio. She helps keep everybody on the straight and narrow. You got all of us just scalawags, and so Angie brings a little, you know, class to the show every time she makes an appearance. Angie Lewis will be here. Plus, it's around the water cooler. Tom James, Buddy Martin, myself, Austin Tappman, talking about today's hot topics in sports. Tom James has a great question today. I'm going to give it to you now, Austin, so you can think about it.
All right.
In what sport does home field advantage matter the most?
It's a pretty good question. Yeah.
Pretty good question, Tom James.
You know what I'm ready for, Tom? Fake or factoid? I'm ready to redeem.
Oh, we were terrible yesterday.
I'm ready to redeem yesterday's debacle.
Oh, it was I just got a headache. All of a sudden, you just gave me a headache just thinking about it. Oh.
We have to face it, though. We might even have to play Angie.
Oh, good. Well, if we played Angie how we played yesterday, she wouldn't have to get one question right. She'd win.
A lot of people would have won against us.
It was terrible. And you know who the worst was?
You.
Chief of Police Greg Graham.
Yeah.
Oh, it was terrible. He was terrible.
Once he got 4 or 5 wrong, he just kind of...
How's this guy the chief? The way he blew fake or factoid.
I guess you don't have to know useless information in order to be the police chief.
Well, that's probably... He's got a lot on his mind, you know, being the police chief. That's probably what his thing was. Right. So I understand that now. That's probably what his thing was. So. All right. Hour 2 coming up. Buddy Martin joins the fray next. Angie Lewis bringing some class to the show. And God knows we need it. All that next on Buddy's, I almost said Buddy's sports page. On the Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Hi, Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name. Need a car? Need financing? Need somebody to cut through the red tape and send you rolling down the highway? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Got great credit and just prefer a quality pre-owned car at a fair price from somebody you can trust? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Want to avoid high pressure to feel appreciated and be able to choose from a wide selection of AutoCheck and Carfax certified vehicles? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala and Bellevue. Prestige. It's all there in our name.
You know, Austin, I'm sitting here at the computer looking at our Facebook page, and boy, we really need to tell more listeners about our Facebook page.
No, Tom, see, you got it all wrong. Twitter is the new age.
What's a tweeter?
No, a Twitter, Tom. The Voice of Ocala has a Twitter.
We do? Well, how do we tell our listeners about that?
All they have to do is get the Twitter app or go to twitter.com, type in Voice of Ocala in the search box, and click follow.
All right, well, what's the tweeter do?
The Voice of Ocala's Twitter page updates all of its followers on the latest news, guests, giveaways, and contests.
Oh, okay. But couldn't listeners just tune in weekdays from 3 to 6 to 1370 AM and 96.3 FM, or even go to online at WOCA.com? Wouldn't that be easier?
Yeah, okay, maybe.
Are you wasting hundreds or thousands of dollars on termite retreat fees? If you're not with Turner Pest Control, you probably are. Turner Pest Control offers the industry's only termite and pest control package that never charges retreat fees, ever. You can get started today for only $99. This is a value of $500 or more. This includes treatments, installation of monitoring stations, quarterly pest control, and a lifetime guarantee, all for an unbelievable low $99. Even if you have another pest control provider, visit turnerpest.com to find out how you can avoid paying those high termite retreat fees.
Hey, it's Christy with Ocala Mac and PC Repair and Ocala Guest Wi-Fi to let you know we have you covered. We are the only local certified Apple and Microsoft computer company in Ocala. We are family owned and operated. From mobile repair to wireless networks, viruses, new systems, or security cameras, we do it all. Check us out online, ocalamacpc.com, or give us a call, 352-566-8324.
Tell them Nick, Madison, or Mason sent you and get free diagnostic.
Get your internet telephone service from the company that brought affordable internet service to Ocala in the first place. Olive Save is a sister company of Ocala Guest Wi-Fi, a company you've known and trusted for all your internet needs. Whether you need a phone or hundreds, we've got the products and services to meet your needs both now and in the future. Our plans include everything from local and long-distance calling to equipment maintenance and even software upgrades. You can count on Olive Save to give you cost certainty knowing that your bill will be the same next week, next month, or even next year. Call 352-450-8647 today to learn how to cut your monthly telephone bill up to 60%.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offered as an uncle dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
We've heard a lot about data breaches at major retailers, and we could hear of many more in the future. The internet security firm McAfee says 40 million credit card users, rather numbers, are up for sale to scammers on the black market. General Motors has a new lawyer in charge of the investigation of an ignition problem in some older cars, which led to more than a dozen deaths. He's a former U.S. attorney. Congress is also investigating and says it could take action. Many of us have had senior moments well before we've reached our golden years. Here's one reason why we don't need to worry about them. A German study finds only about 20% of people who experience the forgetfulness, memory lapses, and poor judgment will go on to develop serious brain-related disorders like Alzheimer's disease. Our national emergency is over. Twitter is up and running again. The microblogging site went down briefly this afternoon. Twitter says it was for maintenance, so you can go back to documenting your life in 140-character bursts. This is ABC News.
Right now at the Home Depot, get a 10-year sealed battery smoke and carbon monoxide alarm start at just $24.97. So, let's worry less. Let's do smarter fire safety. Alarms that won't turn off and batteries that won't chirp for 10 long years. Let's do this. Get a worry-free alarms starting at just $24.97. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. U.S. only. See store for details.
You need a website. Why not do it yourself? You know your business. With Wix.com, you can create a professional website all by yourself. It's easy and free. With Wix.com, you don't need to be a programmer. Just use the intuitive drag-and-drop website builder. There's no limit to how creative you can be. It's your website, your style. Show the world what you can do. Create your own stunning website today. Go to Wix.com. It's easy and free.
Yes, it's time again for Buddy Martin. Call him up and tell him what you're thinking. But be kind because he's doing the best he can.
I'm just sick of all the amateur stuff, you know? I mean, like, if I'm paying top dollar, I want a little production value, you know? Like some editing, transition, something, some music.
Don't worry, we didn't leave you.
He's gone? He's not gone! That's the whole point! He's never gone!
Our bosses say we gotta stay.
Check out the name tag. You're in my world now, Grandma.
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei!
It's time for the second hour of The Voice of Ocala.
Hoo-ah!
You ever come across anything like time travel?
Come on, stick around. It's free.
If you win, you win. If you lose, you still win.
Hello, welcome to Hour 2 of the program. I'm Buddy Martin, joining the program in progress of what's left of it. We have given away the furniture. I think we got a couple of tables left and pretty much out of business thanks to Tom and his Trivinator show and his prizes. And
he will not, tough couple of weeks.
He will not be paid this week because all of his money will be used to buy new prizes when you give away the entire store as you did, my friend. You were very, very generous.
It's been a tough week.
Yeah.
I don't. You know, I have no excuse. It's just been a tough week.
All right. And I thought you were talking about Waldo the whole time on that speed trap, because that's...
You liked that, didn't you?
Yeah. Well, she's setting me up to say Waldo, I know, and then you said Hampton. But Waldo ought to be put out of business. Waldo's... If Hampton's more criminal...
And it is.
...corrupt, then it's in bad shape.
Yeah. At least Waldo can document where all the money it gets from speeding fines goes.
Right.
Hampton can't document it.
Yeah, it goes in the pockets of people in Hampton, apparently. So,
cops standing out there with a radar gun and an AR-15.
Yeah. Okay, on the program today, Angie Lewis will be along. We have a couple of topics to discuss. One of them is, I don't watch this show, but I'll just say, apparently, this question is being asked, is Juan Pablo the worst bachelor ever? That's what they're talking about. And we'll see if Angie watches it. Also, what the Pope did not say, but we are led to believe that he did say. Sometimes these things should be taken for a grain of salt. Plus, Angie, fake or factoid, and you guys got a whole lot of redeeming to do, as you said, Austin. You have some penance to play what was undoubtedly the single worst day. How long have we been playing fake or factoid? Over a year, right? At least, Tom?
About 8 months.
No, it's been longer than that. It's been longer than that. I'm pretty sure. Anyway, whatever longs me, it's by far the worst day ever for our staff on Fake or Factoid. I'm giving bonuses to our crack research staff, by the way, who absolutely just stymied, smoked you guys yesterday.
They did.
Man. And I'll tell you why in my go-long segment, why people love this Gator basketball team. Absolutely in love. You know, speaking of Gators, a gentleman's here has got two really great books. You mentioned Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, which Douglas is a good Adam. Book, but not as good as the books that our friends got.
Oh, he's got Dan Jenkins' new book?
No, he ain't got that. Dan, that's good now. I like that. But he's got Steve Plisco, who has been corresponding with me. He's back and forth from Palm Beach, got an event going on. Bought a couple of books and asked me to sign them for an auction. I should have told him as soon as I sign them, the value goes down, but that's just how it works. But he came in today with a copy of Urban Sway and the Boys from Old Florida. And I want to welcome Steve for a brief minute to the show and say thank you for buying the book, Steve.
Thank you, sir.
Hey, you got, what is this event you got going on in Gainesville?
Yeah, on March 29th, we're holding our annual event to benefit the University of Florida School of Theater and Dance as well as the School of Music. It's an annual event. It's been held for the last 5 years. There's student performances in the theater, an after party with live jazz and dancing, a full service bar, silent auction for which you've signed your books, and one of our, besides your books, top auction items this year will be an opportunity to meet Celine Dion in Las Vegas and get tickets to her show.
I'll swap you the books if I can get the tickets to see Celine Dion. That would be a, whoever gets that has got a great one. So that's a, and this all both benefit what?
The School of Theater and Dance.
Theater, very
and
nice.
The School of Music.
Very right. Now you obviously have a connection there.
I'm on
you,
the board.
You live in Palm Beach, right?
Yes, sir. I have a daughter that's a member of the dance department, yeah. And a daughter that's now going to be a BFA acting student there.
Nice. Well, do the dance school have any connection to the Dazzlers that dance for the Gator basketball team?
Unrelated.
Unrelated. Okay. So I don't know a lot about. I know the theater school is very good. I don't know much about the dance. It's the dance department of Goodman?
Yeah, it's definitely world renowned.
Really? A lot of ballet or?
Mostly modern and contemporary.
Jazz and whatever,
yes,
yeah.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Interesting. Well, I want to wish you a lot of luck on the event up there and all the best. I hope you get more than $5. If you don't get more than $5, write me and I'll write you a check to make up the difference. But all the best to you. And thanks for coming in on a busy day to drop in and say hi.
No problem. Thank you for your time.
Thanks for buying the books.
Okay, sir.
All the best. What's the date again?
It's March 29th.
March 29th. And how do people get information if they want to go?
They can go to the UF website or they could just Google Splendor, Splendor at UF, and it'll come right up.
Splendor at UF.
Yes, sir.
You can remember that. Thanks a lot.
All right, thank you, sir. Have a great day.
All the best. All right, coming up in the next segment, we will talk about, first of all, I want to say happy birthday to my dear friend and mentor, his 88th, Jim Head, who lives over in Beverly Hills, Florida, who was a former editor of a number of papers, Parade Magazine, also Florida Today, which he was the first founding editor of that. He was editor of many, editorial page editor of the Tampa Tribune, and many great jobs, and a veteran newspaper man. And he's 88 today, and all the best to you, Jim. Doing great, and hope you have a great one. Also, get well soon to Mel Tillis. In honor of Mel, could you pull up some of Mel Tillis for me over there, please, Austin, as we go out, maybe get a little Mel Tillis music. I don't know, Coca-Cola Cowboy, one of those songs. Mel had surgery over the weekend, and Mel is, he had open heart surgery, a quadruple bypass. I spoke today to his good friend John Alvarez, who, by the way, will be on the show with us on Friday to talk about Ocala's Got Talent show for Project Hope. And he told me, he talked to Mel. Mel called him on Saturday and said, I'm in Vanderbilt Hospital. I've been operated on. I'm doing good. And apparently, he's up and around up there. But a lot of folks don't know that Mel Tillis lives right here in Ocala. And Mel has been on the show before. And he, of course, is legendary. He's written like 800 songs in Nashville Country Music Hall of Fame, et cetera, et cetera. Songwriters Hall of Fame. So we wish get well quick to Mel Tillis. And all the best to him. And hopefully, we'll get a chance to talk to him again soon. It was quite a day today. Apparently, Twitter crashed.
You know what? I saw that because I came into work and uploaded our, or pulled up our Twitter page, mm-hmm. and Twitter said, sorry, yeah. we're uploading or doing something to it.
We didn't crash it, did we?
We might have.
Hmm. Well, it crashed, apparently. There were people sort of panicked. You know, it's one of those things you get. I use it all the time.
Right.
I would definitely have withdrawals because I'm literally on it all the time, especially from the hours of noon to 2:30 or quarter to 3. I use it a lot. And at nighttime, I would bet you that I probably go through 500 tweets a day easily.
Yeah.
Probably more like 700 a day. Every one I get almost. And I've got, I don't know, something like a close to 1,000 followers, and I follow about 2,000 people.
It's such a big source of news for everybody.
Well,
seems like that if it were to go down.
Because you can pick who you want to hear from and exactly. what you want to hear, and you can get stories off of there, which are great. And I put my blog up on the Gators as well right. yesterday. And so
I actually crashed.
Yeah, I'm sure you did, no doubt about it. So everybody say
I was on Twitter today when it went down.
Well, there you
All
go.
Of a sudden I was there, and then it wasn't there, and then Twitter came up and said, sorry.
I knew you had a hand in it. Somehow you're involved in it. So. New show last night, at least for me to watch. I'm sure it's been around for a while. I'll talk about that. And I don't watch this, but I bet you Angie Lewis has watched it, and we'll find out from her if she has or if she does. They're talking about Juan Pablo and not making very many points with people, especially women. Some people asking the question, is he the worst bachelor ever? Now, not watching the show, I wouldn't know that, but that's what they're asking about on Twitter. Is he the worst bachelor ever? Maybe you can... Sure
what show to. Is this?
The Bachelor.
Okay, so the guy's a bachelor, but what show's he on?
Yeah, there you go. And I'll tell you what the Pope did not say, even though people think that he did. We do have a little bit of a rewind with Chief Graham. Is that soundbite up?
Yes.
We are not replaying Fake or Factoid.
Yes, we are. What did you pull up? What spot did you pull up?
It was a bite where he was talking about how his people, you brought up True Detective, which you talked right. about yesterday, and how right. his people live and basically yeah. see that dark side of True Detective.
I'm glad you pulled up one, because if you watch True Detective, you know how dark it is.
Yeah.
And we talked about the fact that, well, you'll hear the tweet, but about the fact that his people see darkness all the time, and that's one of the reasons they have a high mortality rate and why their heart attacks are so prevalent among the law enforcement officers, which is one reason why he's out doing the walk this year and the heart walk again for the second straight year. So that was the point. That's a good bite. And Dan Jenkins, I think we all thoroughly enjoyed Dan Jenkins.
Yes.
And one of our better...
We could have replayed the whole entire interview with him today.
Can I tell you, last night I was doing trivia at Mojo's, and I had a man come up to me that I did not know. He comes trivia regularly, but I did not know he listens to the show regularly. He said, I was listening today, and one of my favorite people was on your show.
You said me?
And it was, and I said, well, I'm always on the show. That's what I said. He said, yeah, well, you're not my favorite person. He said he has been a fan of Dan Jenkins for as long as he can remember. The man I'm talking about is in his mid-70s. Mm-hmm. So he'd been a fan of Dan Jenkins and loved how Dan Jenkins talked about yesterday the relationship he had with
Ben Hogan.
Ben Hogan.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if you're a Hogan lover, he's...
He said it harkened him back to his days of youth when before Tiger, before Jack, before Arnie, Ben Hogan was it.
Great time. And the great thing about Dan is he's not just living the old days. He also lives in the modern age. All right. She's in the house, folks. She already has brightened her day, and I'm sure she has much more to say. It'll make the show a lot more enlightening than what it is right now.
And a lot more classy.
And probably we'll do a little bit better on Faker Factoid than you guys did yesterday.
Good up next, night.
Angie Lewis of Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is in the house coming up next right here on The Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM. If you want to join us in the conversation, you can do so by texting us, 352-507-5352. You can reach The Voice of Ocala through text, 352-507-5352, right here at The Source.
Since 1976, Daniel L. Hightower, a lawyer, has been fighting for accident victim justice in North Central Florida and statewide. He believes everyone in America should follow the rules, including the insurance companies. He and his firm have experience fighting for victims of personal injury, wrongful death, workers' compensation, and Social Security disability, as well as serving those in need of help with bankruptcy, simple wills, and estate plans. The mission at the law offices of Daniel L. Hightower, PA, is to represent deserving clients and recover the maximum benefits they are entitled to by law in a timely manner. In personal injury and workers' compensation cases, there are no fees or costs unless a recovery is made. The law office of Daniel L. Hightower is located at 7 East Silver Springs Boulevard, Suite 300. For your free consultation, call 352-629-7777 or 1-888-LAW-1976 and visit danhightower.com for more information. Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice, and the proud sponsor of Ask the Cops.
This reprise of Ask the Cops is proudly brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
On this episode of Ask the Cops, Sheriff Chris Blair talks about sex trafficking in the Marion County area.
Well, the thing is, I mean, we had a number of cases, and, you know, we had one last year where the subject picked up a 16 and a 13-year-old. They were hitchhikers in Marion County, and basically we made a case against him, and he's doing 15 years with 10 years of probation. And we're presently working a couple of cases right now with Florida Department of Law Enforcement on cases similar to that, and you know, they're ongoing at this point, so within the next couple of weeks, might be a month, but we will be able to discuss those type cases. So they're ongoing investigations, so I can get into the details of them. But you're right, buddy. I mean, it is here. It's in the state of Florida and throughout the country. So it's something that we got to become very, very proactive.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, the new old-fashioned bank. Let us introduce you to Okus, a simple way to bring your business online. Through this relationship, your business can have a fully functioning website in less than 30 minutes. We will also provide you support with social media, sales tracking, e-commerce, and online scheduling, which is all optimized for mobile users. Okus, now at Gateway Bank, Silver Springs Boulevard, Ocala. Come visit our technology center for your total small business solution. I'm Tom Ingram, and I'll see you there.
The sound of the bat cracking, the crowd cheering, the smell of overpriced but tasty hot dogs, the memories that will last a lifetime of your first baseball game with little Johnny. Your team wins. It was a great night until you get home. It's 9 p.m. and your wife says you have no water.
We have no water.
What do you do?
What do you do?
Rule number one, don't panic. Remain calm. Okay, that's two rules.
We don't have time for jokes, funny man.
Okay, think back. On the way home, you heard a radio commercial.
Mike's got plumbing. If water runs through it, we do it.
Eureka. You saved the day. You remembered that Mike's got plumbing doesn't charge extra for nights, weekends, or holidays. You are a genius.
Hey, Mr. Genius, did you remember the phone number?
Of course you did. Remember, you're a genius. 352-237-2888. Because at Mike's got plumbing, if water runs through it, we do it. Even if water's not running through it at this particular moment. Mike's got plumbing.
Hi, Robin. You look tired.
I am. I've been running all over town.
Why? Why not drive?
I need to get this stupid document notarized.
Well, that's easy. You need personal service.
Duh. That's what I've been looking for.
You need to go see Mark at the Personal Service Center. He can notarize that for you, make copies, fax it wherever, or send it out in the mail. Heck, he can even scan it and email it for you.
Really? Where is he at?
2375 Northeast 25th Avenue, on the corner of Northeast 25th Avenue and 24th Street. You can call him at 789-6683.
Personal Service Center. Thanks, Larry.
Your home is safe, or is it? AA Lock, Dock, and Security. The name has been a staple in Ocala since 1985. Do you have the right equipment in place to have peace of mind when you are at home or away? AA Lock, Dock, and Security has the right people to install and monitor your home or business. Call today for a free on-site security analysis. Call 867-1965. AA Lock, Dock, and Security, 219 Northwest 10th Street, 867-1965.
Hey, back on the Voice of Ocala. Time now for Here's Angie. Hello, Angie. How are you? Good to talk to you again, and glad you made it back.
Yes, I missed you all last week.
No, it's not the same, Angie. It's not the same. So, in fact, I think did we vote to shut the show down when she's not here? Did we do that?
Yeah, we did.
Okay, well, there you go. So, if you don't come along, there's no Voice of Ocala on Tuesday. So,
I'll make sure I make it the rest of the
time. We've been doing this a while, kid.
We've
been doing this a while, yeah. So, and glad to have you back.
Thank you. Okay, I have to give a shout out to a listener today. And he knows you. Don Kelso.
Oh, money or something? Or
yeah, exactly. But the agent who actually that retired when I moved here and took over his agency, Mr. Don Kelso, stopped in the office today, and he said he was going to be trying to listen to the show.
Don. So, yeah, I know Don Kelso.
So great man. Just a super guy. So it was good to see him. He looks great. He's, he lives in outside of Nashville, Tennessee is where they retired. Now I'm going to draw a blank.
Not Donaldson, is it?
No.
Because I lived in Donaldson once.
Yeah. I don't think so. Right. Yeah, but
Murfreesboro?
No, it's Lebanon, like a small little area.
Lebanon, Tennessee. That's right outside of Nashville.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Anyway, not important. Well, thank you. Thanks for bringing that up. And we were just talking during the break about all the activities that you have. And you've got your skirt in the wind once again with the Silver Springs International Film Festival. And it looks like it's coming together really nice. It's been sort of bubbling over. And now I know that you got probably the hardest job of anybody. Well, maybe next to Greg Thompson.
Oh.
To put all these videos, those films together.
Oh, poor Greg, yeah.
But you've got to orchestrate the downtown piece of this. I got to tell you a story.
Hey, let's not tell anybody that. Let's wait till it's over and see how it goes.
I want to tell you a story about the whole thing. You know how we're battling the idea of where the film festival is going to be held?
Yes.
We keep saying, I love that it was called the Silver Springs International Film Festival because it hooks us up with the history of Silver Springs.
Right, exactly.
And I love that. But as we've discovered into the deal one day, hey, look, it says Hollywood Happens Here. There's a picture of a glass bottom boat. It looks like what? It's in Silver Springs. So lo and behold, I have a friend named Mike O'Neill. Mike O'Neill's brother was an actor in Hollywood for years, a lot of famous movies, and who's from Ocala. Pat O'Neill is now dead. And Mike was here for a class reunion. I happened to run across him. And he knows about the film festival. And I said, you should come down because your collection of the family in Hollywood, I can't make it this year. He says, I was out at Silver Springs yesterday. He said, and I looked at it and I said, where are you going to put that festival?
Oh, okay.
Well, yeah. Mike, it's not going to be at Silver Springs. It's going to be downtown. Oh, it is?
Yeah.
So there you go. So we have to remind folks, it's not at Silver Springs, and that's where Angie comes in.
Right.
And you can tell them about downtown if you want to.
And I'll tell you, even before we go there, it was kind of fun with one of our last meetings when Greg Thompson was talking about just all these, the filmmakers and the response that we've gotten. And we've got the 54 films slotted and everything for the programming. And I looked over at Greg and I looked at Lori and you guys and I'm like, oh no, this is really happening. So we've got a great, on the springsfilmfest.com, you can go and see the events are going to be happening. But, you know, a lot of people, if you just want to, you know, go to the screenings or single tickets and stuff, but that dive in all access passes is really quite incredible because it's going to get you into everything. And Thursday night's going to kick off with we're calling it the downtown dinner tour. Mm-hmm. And when you check in at the Brick City Center of the Arts, you'll get designated a certain area, which will give you four merchants downtown. Now, it's not all of them are restaurants. We actually have, like, Gos & Sons is partnering with Harry's, but the food's going to be at Gos & Sons.
Okay.
Marketplace on Broadway is having food brought in. So Shannon Roth.
Yeah, all right.
But then we also
food.
Have Mark's and Feta and everybody, you know. Yeah. So you'll get four restaurants or retailers, names and a little map, and it'll, you know, and you go there and they'll have food and drinks and things for you.
You get one drink with that?
Yeah, maybe one, or you know, they're each one is kind of doing a different thing. With your pass, and then from 6 to 8, so you can go visit those four spots on your way to the theater. And then when you get to the theater, is going to be the toast and the kickoff to the film festival. With the screening, we can announce Creature from the Black Lagoon, which I think is just going to be so fun to see on the big screen and do that. And then that's Thursday night, and then
plus a little surprise lead off video that would be kind of neat,
right?
Too.
Exactly, and there's going to be all kinds of little surprises. Oh, and just even the girls that we're going to have handing out the champagne toast and stuff, full costumes that we're having made and stuff. That these girls are going to look incredible. And
it's a big deal.
It is a very big deal. And then, you know, of course, Friday then from 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. screenings, so people can go and, you know, and they can start going to the website soon and kind of seeing, you know, okay, when do you want to go attend a screening? What films are you interested in seeing, and everything? And then that's also First Friday Art Walk. So there's going to be a lot of stuff going on downtown that evening. And then the incredible jazz funk band Serotonic will be on the square until 11:30 at
They're
night.
Really good.
They're
too.
So good. They're just like big band, you know, full energy. So, you know, have all that going on. And then Saturday again, 11 a.m. screenings start again up until 6 o'clock. And then after that is going to be the, I'm so excited about this street dinner party, where we're going to have the street marked off from where Starbucks is all the way down to Fort King, and have the two longest dinner tables in Ocala. And it, the restaurants are Mark's, Cuvée, La Cuisine, Stella's, Braised Onion, Chef Randall. I mean, 10 really great restaurants where if you have a ticket to this event, you can come and just enjoy that, an elegant dinner in the street.
Right in front of the Marion Theater.
Right in front of the Marion Theater. Stage will be set up. We'll be doing the awards at that time, presenting the awards to the filmmakers. And then another great band is going to be playing that night. So just a fun street party. I think it's going to be a great community event. Come back Sunday, 1 to 5, and be able to view the best of the best and view all the award-winning films. So it is a fun, full weekend.
I'm laughing at you because you're so programmed. You know every little thing is happening every day. And you go to bed at night and your head's spinning, I know. And you're
I
thinking
have
about,
not
oh,
slept in weeks. I'm not going to lie.
That's fabulous, Angie. That's fabulous. Well, you know who's going to be really working hard during this time is the police department. They're going to be there and taking care of folks, so it's safe downtown.
That's right.
Wonderful. And we had, you know, our chief is a very active guy in the community. I'm sure he'll be there and around and probably part of it in some way. And, of course, he'll have his men out there. But he is, like you, he's involved in other charitable things, and he's very big in the Heart Walk, you know. And
right.
He was here yesterday talking about the Heart Walk. And we talked about the TV show True Detective. Have you seen that show?
True to know.
Yeah, you probably wouldn't like it.
Okay.
It's very dark.
It's
one of the Matthew McConaughey and Woody Harrelson on
HBO. Okay, I probably would like it.
Well, it's kind of like The Rage right now. Just finish.
Yeah.
Just finish.
Oh, it's on HBO?
Yeah.
Yeah, I always have to wait till those are done so I can watch them on Netflix.
Yeah, well, yeah. Well, you can watch that. You could do it on Netflix, I'm sure. And McConaughey and Woody are really, really good in this.
Yeah.
In fact, McConaughey helped. Anyway.
He's incredible.
Yeah, this show is dark and very dark. And I said, so dark, I almost turned it off a couple times. The chief made a very interesting observation about the reality and the Hollywood version of what is dark. And this is what Chief Graham had to say.
Okay. You got
to let up Austin late, say what he said about what is reality and what is on the silver screen. So,
yeah, I mean, we've worked cases where they're, you know, those serial killers, mass murderers, senseless stuff. I mean, and I've been peripherally involved in some cases that still affect me to this day, and it affects, I remember we had a death of a child that was the same age as my child at the time, and it had a incredible impact on me, and I still think about it today, and I wasn't the victim. I didn't know the victim. We helped work the case, but it really does, you're exposed to a segment of society, a very sick, it's almost unspeakable stuff that some people do out there. And the problem is because you're exposed to it so much, you tend to start thinking the entire world's that way. Yeah. And it's not. I mean, the world's great, but,
that's your reality during the time when you're watching it. Like,
well, yeah, because that's what we deal with on a daily basis all the time. And I tell you, at least the men and women of the Ocala Police Department, they do a great job of separating their personal lives from that. You know, the one thing I preach is gain your identity by who you are, not by what you do. And I think they truly do that. And it makes them better public servants. But it does take a toll on you. It takes a toll on your family. It takes a toll on your health. And that's why we don't live very long after we retire.
So, Chief makes a good point there. You know, and I know you see as an agent occasionally devastation, you know, their insurance,
yeah,
which
exactly.
has a very – my mother worked at the sheriff's office for 20 years, and she would come home some nights, and I could tell she was worried about me, and she'd say, be very careful out there, son. And I thought, don't worry about me. I'm fine. Yeah, but there's some evil people in this world. You know, I hear about them all the time. So it just all depends on what your perspective is. And I loved what the chief said there about it. You could see he almost took a gasp when he talked about the little girl's kill. He had a girl the same age. So
right.
Anyway, I love that he is honest and frank about that.
Right.
And he also is an upbeat person. I mean, you really couldn't be around, well, except for you. You're Miss Sunshine. He's a very upbeat person all the time. So I want to get that in there. All right, now let's talk about TV. Do you watch The Bachelor and be honest about it?
Okay, actually, no.
No, come on now.
I don't.
You don't watch it?
I don't watch The Bachelor.
Your daughter doesn't watch it?
I think that's the most ridiculous show
I do too.
On TV.
I do too. It's phony. It's
the only time I ever watched it was when Allie, what's her name? Allie?
I couldn't tell.
Whatever.
Kirstie Allie? I don't know.
And it's because there was a State Farm agent that was, he was The Bachelor. And he and Allie, you know, that was the whole thing. And that's the only time I ever watched it.
Yeah, okay.
Other than that, crazy.
There's a TV show called The Bachelor?
It's so ridiculous. Well, here's the thing. One, how do you, they spend like 2 hours with this person. And then they're all going, oh, we're so much in love and all that. I'm like, you don't even know this person. And then one person's kissing them. The other person's kissing them. It's disgusting.
Yeah. What is the deal with that? What could ever be sincere about having to kiss a woman when you kissed 9 others right before that?
Sounds like a party in the 80s.
Not
even a party.
I don't even get
you didn't
that
go to
show.
The parties I went I to.
Other
don't.
Kinds of parties I don't go to.
I don't get it. So, okay, so apparently something's going. I don't watch it, so I don't know
anything. He picked his final one.
Okay.
I don't know. I thought everybody watched. I don't. And I don't like you. I don't like it. But, in fact, they're saying this guy. Now, think about the show genre. First of all, it's a bad show. Secondly, yeah. He apparently is the worst bachelor ever. That's what they're calling him. It says everyone in the show is just so over him and can't wait for this season to be over. A source connected to the show said. So there you go, Juan Pablo. See you later, Jack.
You know what? Here's my deal with TV. I'm not probably not the best person to talk about those things. Yeah. If it's not on Netflix or it's not a sports, the only thing I watch on TV live is sports. Yeah. And then
the Cardinals are.
Or you know, but football,
USF,
hockey, and stuff. But then you know, anything else I watch on Netflix. So I'm not the best person to.
So you don't watch that?
I don't.
Well.
Oh, I do watch The Voice. Okay, there's a show I watch.
Yeah, I watched that Sunday night.
Yeah. Oh, last night, the lowest ratings.
I didn't watch it last
listen
night.
Listen to this. The lowest ratings they've ever had on The Voice last night.
Why? Really?
Yeah.
I wonder what it was.
Lowest ratings, and they had a show called Believe. Now, I watched that show
last night, too.
All right.
Believe.
I liked it.
Was it
I
on at the
it.
Same time? Is that
no,
what it was?
No, it was right after it.
Well, it did overlap for a while. Right? It was on 10 o'clock. And when what time was The Voice over?
10 o'clock. It came on right after The Voice. It's on NBC.
Yeah, so I flipped through and watched The Voice just a little bit, not much, maybe 5 minutes. Occasionally I check in because we didn't have our show on last night, The Blacklist.
Right.
And it was
in it'll be back next week.
It was in The Blacklist time slot. And I thought, honestly, is the last resort. I said, you can put on whatever you want to, Johnny. I'm not watching. So I went online.
Yeah.
And so she said, let's watch this progress. Okay, right.
Yeah.
I thought, this is going to be another one of those garbage shows or something. And I watched it. And I thought, well, you know.
It's a pretty good show.
Was it good?
Pretty
okay.
good. So I'll stay with it.
It's about a little girl that may or may not be the savior of the earth. You don't know.
Has superpowers.
Okay.
Superpowers. But anyway, it's a good play. It's well written and well thought out so far.
So far, yeah. So
we'll see where it goes. But
we had a show like that called, what was that show with Dylan McDermott, Hostages? That the first couple shows were pretty good, and then it lost me.
So right. I wonder what happened with The Voice, why their ratings were so low last night.
And they actually had a pretty good segment there.
Because they've had some really talented people on it.
Yeah.
Sunday night was, I watched it Sunday night. It was a pretty good show Sunday night.
Yeah, I thought so,
Here's
too.
What you have to know about. This is why The Bachelor is so baloney phony. My son, as you know, was on a reality show, and so was Clint, by the way.
Yes.
My son was on a show called Want to Be a Hilton.
Want to Be a Hilton.
Yeah. And he was on 6 episodes of it, and he was in New York. And he said, Dad, if you only knew what these producers did to people, ply them with booze, whatever they can do, they want you to say, or they go out and party, they want to get a camera in your face and stir you up and get you to say things. And so how much of the could the bats really be true? How much of this? If I'm a girl, I'm looking at this Juan Pablo, and I'm calling BS right off the bat.
Well, first,
there's nothing he can say to me that has 1 ounce of credibility. That's
first off, they may get him liquored up, wined up, and everything. And the girl the next morning goes, I did what with who on camera?
I don't know about that part in the liquor, but I'm talking about the other reality shows.
I was goofing. I know what The Bachelor is. Every time that you see it, they're drinking wine. They're in hot tubs drinking wine.
Well, you watched it. So
the liquor, the booze is flowing.
Well, he's watched every one.
I mean, it's like when it all started with The Real World.
Yeah. The booze flowed on The Real World.
Yeah, for sure.
All right. That's why Jersey Shore was so good a show, because they didn't hide it. They showed you they were drunks.
All right, we've had enough of the dark talk and all the stuff about bachelors. Let's go over to the good side and come back. Have you followed anything the Pope has said?
Yes.
Have you followed?
Well,
okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you know, we all kind of like him.
Yeah.
Because he's some of the things he said. I read something a week ago or so, 10 days. I thought, this just sounds a little different. I mean, could he really say something like this? So it was printed in some newspapers. I thought, that really sounds weird. So I'm going to tell you the real story about that when I come back, because this goes to show you what you had to be careful about on the internet. Coming up next right here on the Voicebook Hour.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Hi, it's Lisa Midget, owner of the brand new Property Salon. It's a perfect time to freshen up your cut and color for the new year. And if you really want to change up your look, talk to us about Hotheads extensions for extra volume and length. How about a blowout for date night? Give us a call. Enjoy some me time while you relax in our newly renovated salon and check in on Facebook using our free Wi-Fi. We know you'll be happy with your new look. We guarantee it. Our style guarantee assures you that no matter what, you will love your hair, or we will fix it for free. Call for your appointment today. 352-351-1771. We're located in downtown Ocala, next to the Southside Deli. Tell us Buddy sent you for 20% off your first service visit. Now hiring licensed cosmetologists, nail techs, and front desk staff. Visit our website, theproperties.com, for our online application. The Properties Salon, timeless elegance meets classic sex.
Men, do you know your testosterone level? Are you experiencing decreased energy levels or unusual sleeping problems? Have you noticed you have less strength or endurance, decreased sex drive, increased irritability or depression? If so, you may be experiencing problems with low testosterone. If you're interested in a free testosterone screening, please call Renstar Medical Research at 352-629-5800. Again, that number is 352-629-5800.
This is Austin Tavern reminding you to stay in contact with us at WOCA. Find us on Twitter and Instagram at Voice of Ocala. Make sure to become a friend of our Facebook page and call us at 622-9622.
Hi, I'm Angie Lewis. Let's talk every Tuesday afternoon on WOCA, the Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
WOCA, Ocala.
Pick up your copy of Lady Lake Magazine, featuring local businesses and issues and written by local volunteers. Lady Lake Magazine has become a must-read in Marion, Lake, and Sumter counties, audited by Circulation Verification Council and serving the area for 23 years. Plus, Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. All we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 352-804-1223 and pick up your copy of Lady Lake Magazine today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Legally Yours, brought to you by Fuller & Fuller Attorneys at Law. On the air every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. with John Fuller, a board-certified civil trial lawyer for over 25 years. John welcomes your questions, from business to complex family matters to legal disputes. So tune in every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. for Legally Yours with John Fuller, right here on WOCA 1370 a.m. and 96.3 FM, The Source.
Gene Powell Pass Chemowing. Our tractor services include bush hog, disking, front end loader, box blade, and stump grinding. We also have zero turn mowers for the smaller paddocks, aisleways, fence rows, and lawn care. Fence row spraying is also available for weed control. We are licensed and insured. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing, 352-629-2440, or online at PowellGene, G-E-N-E, at yahoo.com. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing.
Habitat for Humanity of Marion County is a ministry dedicated to improving lives by providing affordable and decent housing. Help them help others by visiting the Habitat for Humanity Ocala Restore at 926 Northwest 27th Avenue. To schedule a donation, give us a call at 401-0075 and we'll come pick it up. For more information, visit ocalarestore.org. Habitat for Humanity of Marion County. Building homes, building hope, building community.
You've got a garden and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
Back with Andy Lewis. Before we go to the Pope's statement, what are you doing for St. Patty's Day?
I'll be at the Cup of the Irish, as you know.
What a good place to be on St. Patrick's
Day. It's a great place to be on St. Patrick's
Day. Will be green beer involved at all?
They've got, they're doing similar, like a four-band music festival outside. Nice. They'll have all of the staple Irish food and drink, and it's just a fun time. And, you know, family. The thing about that, too, is that it's a place you can bring your kids to as well. So a lot of families come out during that time. It'll be great. So I'll probably be waiting tables more than likely.
Really?
On Saturday.
We'll come to your table, I'm sure.
So I'll be helping out Clint, Reuben, and Tammy.
Yeah,
so.
Good. And we'll check that out. And of course, you mentioned downtown and safety a minute ago, and I think we can rest assured that during all these events coming up, that it's going to be very safe. And it's safe now.
It is. And you know, I had a couple people mention, you know, oh, what about the, and I'm like, no, it's going to, you know, that we're going to have a lot of, you know, like you said, that it's going to be monitored and stuff. But, buddy, I don't know. I guess I'm not ever scared downtown. Are you scared downtown?
No. No, the shooting bothered me a lot, but you know
that was an isolated incident.
And here's the deal.
That was premeditated, and that, you know.
I can tell you this: if you go downtown for the film festival, or whatever, it is the safest place in the city because there'll be more cops there than any place else in Ocala.
Exactly.
So you can be assured. Now that doesn't mean you're going to always say that something's not going to happen.
Right.
You can have 50 cops and stuff could happen, but in terms of policing, yeah, I mean it's going to be absolutely safe, and I have no fears at all about downtown.
Something happened here. I mean, something happened right here at the mall today. You know.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Let's talk about the Pope for a second. All right.
Yeah. Let's talk about the Pope.
All right, here's the deal, Pope Francis. All right. What do you guys think of Pope Francis so far?
I mean, as a Catholic, I think he's the Pope. That's what I think. So you'll never get me to say anything wrong about the Pope.
He's been saying some things, though.
I think he's taking the church in the correct direction. I think he's taking the church back in a direction it needs to be in, but he's also modernizing it at times, too.
His comments are saying get past all the issues, the social issue, whatever, and get back to believing in what your religion says and what your belief in Christ is, and deal with the issues of your neighbor and the things.
Right.
And stop all the noise about the other things, which are important, but not the main message, is what he's saying.
Mm-hmm.
Did you hear the recent speech he made about all religions are true because they are true in the hearts of those who believe in them? What other kind of truth is there? In the past, the church has been harsh on those that deem morally wrong or sinful. Today, we no longer judge. Just like a loving father, we never condemn our children. Our church is big enough for heterosexuals and homosexuals, for the pro-life, for the pro-choice, for conservatives and liberals, even communists are welcome to join us, and we all love and worship the same God.
Did you hear that?
So did the Pope really say that?
No.
Okay.
That sounds good, though.
Yeah, it was actually a spoof. Somebody wrote about it. It was on a website called Diversity, Diversity Chronicle. He also says this, which said also the chorus of thunderous applause, because Muslims, Hindus, and African animists are also made with the very likeness and image of God, to hate them is to hate God. Now, there's a certain amount of truth in that. Now, I'm not saying they should hate people. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that's wrong, but it's to reject them, it's to reject God and the gospel of Christ, whether you worship at church, synagogue, mosque, mandir. It does not matter. Whether we call God Jesus, God Adonai, Allah, or Krishna, we all worship the same God of love, so on and so forth. Well, I mean, you may believe that way, and that, if you want to, that's fine. The Pope's not going to make a statement like that.
So did a Pope make any kind of statement?
Not that, like that.
I mean, but about what that was said.
No,
did he come back and say anything?
I looked it up on Snopes.com, which
okay.
is where you check things out.
Yeah.
And it says here, it says, shortly afterward, links and excerpts referencing this article were being circulated via social media. He said, however, the article was just a spoof. There is no Third Vatican Council, has not been convened. And the blog that was published in the Diversity Chronicle includes a disclaimer noting that the original content of this blog was largely satirical. So you see, you can put things on as a spoof, and they become real to people.
Right.
And that's the danger. And that's not necessarily, they didn't try to mislead you, but you didn't read the fine print, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You got to do your research.
Crazy, man. Are you ready to play some fake or fact? Oh, by the way, anything else going on we need to know about in terms of Angie Lewis State Farm Agency or... You're just kind of going over your investments right now with your clients.
Yeah, what we're doing. Actually, I would advise everyone to do this. So that's why we always take the first quarter of the year. We contact all of our clients that have investments with us, mutual funds, annuities, even cash value life insurance. That's considered an investment. CDs, savings, anything. And we just say, hey, it's time to come in. Let's sit down and kind of let's look back on last year. Let's look forward with timelines for whatever they're wanting their money to do and just making sure they're on track and they're doing the right thing. So it's good to take that time. You know, you can do it any time during the year. We just like to start our year with that planning out, you know, as you're doing a new year. So I encourage all of our listeners to sit down with somebody, you know, and do that.
Tax laws change too. So you have to
I mean, just
that
all of that, you know, yeah. And you just want to, you don't want that surprise. You don't want to get to a certain point and you go, oh, well, I don't have enough money to do the things I want to do, you know, so.
All right. One day we'll talk about Roth versus the regular IRAs,
which I think
is interesting. I learned something about it last week I wanted to talk to you about. We'll take a break, come back, and Angie promises to beat the you-know-what out of Austin and Tom.
She's just going to get one question, right?
Factoid, and we'll see how they hold up on the assault after this timeout on The Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life. From everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on.
WOCA, keeping you in touch with Ocala.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to pet expert Charlotte Reed and veterinarian Dr. Michael C. Fleck. They're calling in live from the Global Pet Expo at the Orange County Convention Center in Orlando.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Mark E. Becker will be with us. He's an attorney and he wants to talk about why more and more people are not using the legal system and are going outside the law to resolve their issues.
Stay tuned for a new quarterly show called Higher Education Happenings with Mike Fallon, Dr. Jennifer Friend, Chris Crystal Flynn and Katie Degner speaking about current higher education topics that impact Marion County students, parents, and the local economy.
And then tune in to Legally Yours. John Fuller is the host of that show. He's an attorney from here in Ocala, and he'll answer your legal questions.
Brandy Cooney and Julie Whitaker is from the Childhood Development Services. They'll be speaking about their fundraising event happening this Saturday, the tour around the world.
All of that plus Fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Higher education can be the stepping stone to a better job or just expanding your creative thinking. Tune in Wednesday at 10 a.m. when we will have a roundtable discussion with representatives from Webster University, St. Leo University, College of Central Florida, and University of Central Florida. You'll learn about all the courses offered and the friendly, nurturing personnel that are there to assist you in reaching your goals. So don't miss this informative insight as to what's available to you right here in Ocala. Wednesday at 10 a.m. right here on WOCA, The Source.
A garden, and we've got a show for you called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
Ocala Radio, WOCA.
Real quick, tweets and quotes, you don't need the music. Number one, the soldier above all people prays for peace, for he must suffer and bear the deepest wounds and scars of war. Douglas MacArthur. Number two, a real friend is the one who walks in when the rest of the world walks out. Anonymous. Number three, troubles are like a lot of people. They grow bigger if you nurse them. Mm. All pretty good, but stay serious. Let's play a little bit of tweets and quotes. Roll that factoid. Roll that music. Would you, Austin?
Can we just not play today after yesterday? Can we just quit and let Angie win?
All the books in Dumbledore's office in the Harry Potter movies are just yellow pages rebound to look old.
Fact.
Anybody want to change their answer? You guys should listen to me yesterday. All right, you're all correct. But just when I give you an opt out, you know, sometimes you need to do that. Number two, Harry Potter books are banned in China, Taiwan, and parts of Madagascar.
Fact.
Fake.
Fact.
Two facts and one fake, and the fake is correct. Angie, you go up one there. Angie's correct. It's fake.
Well, only because of Madagascar. I know they're banned in China.
Well, hey, look.
Okay. So you added Madagascar to it.
Now you're second guessing my questions.
Well, I know they're banned in China.
Well, good. Good for you, but you didn't get the answer right. Okay.
No, number three, you threw Madagascar in there.
Number three, cockatoos. I'm going to go to trivia one night, and I'm going to say, what kind of question is that?
You're making
number
that
three,
up.
Number three, cockatoos can translate some Portuguese words to English.
Fake.
Fact.
Anybody want to change their answer? Angie's correct again. It's fake, and you guys are wrong. You both got two misses, and Angie got none. Wow.
Why are we playing this game? Yeah. Such a terrible game.
Number four.
Who
rats,
came up with this game?
Number four, rats and mice laugh when they are tickled.
Fact.
Fake. I mean, no. Oh, wait. Okay, they laugh when they're tickled, rats and mice?
Mm-hmm.
Fake.
Yeah, let's just go out in a burning flame. Fact.
Angie misses one. It is fake. I mean, it's fact. Excuse me. It's fact. Number five, most boa constrictors tie themselves in a knot while asleep.
Fact.
Fake.
Angie, it's fake.
Let two to two to two.
Now we're tied up, aren't we?
You to answer,
and
they're
going to go. I know.
They're going opposite, see?
Darn.
What they did on you there, see? Don't let them get away with that. All right, here we go.
We're all tied.
Second round.
All right.
Crows have 250 different warning calls, including one for cats, one for hawks, and another one for humans.
Fact.
Fake.
But it won't change? It's fact. Austin's out. It's
out.
Tom and Angie. All right, here we go. Number two. Nintendo began in 1889 and made playing cards.
Fact.
Fake. I'm saying fake.
Fact.
Don't let him win again, please. It's fake. It's fact. I mean, you're right. Tom's right. It's fact.
Man.
Yeah, oh, man. That's
all right.
All right, finish it out. All pinball machines made prior to 1960 were made by Gottlieb in Chicago.
Fact.
I have no idea.
Just guess. Fact.
Okay, fact.
No, it's fake.
It oh, darn. Fake. I see right. Now she's going to...
It's predicted that in how many years our sun will run out of fuel and turn into a red giant. How many years? What happens?
2 billion.
2 billion, he says.
5 billion.
5 billion, Austin says.
All right, I'll go with 1 billion.
1 billion. Austin hit it right on the number.
Five billion.
Awesome.
1 billion years.
There you go. All right. All right, guys. Angie, good to be with you. Thanks for coming in once again. Don't forget, Silver Springs International Film Festival. It's the 17th. You've got it's the 17th is the date of St. Patrick's Day, isn't it?
Right.
Yes.
Cup.
Yes.
They're going to have a lot of Irish stuff going
actually,
on.
Actually, it'll be on the 15th.
They'll have 15th, and then they will again have stuff going on the 17th
okay,
as well.
Okay, 15th to the 17th. Mm-hmm. If you don't want to get your Irish on, go out and check the folks out at Cup of the Irish.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Lewis.
Thank you, guys. Good to see you again.
Good to see you. Coming up next, it's Around the Water Cooler with Tom James and the gang. Lots of stuff to talk about in sports, including those Gators after this timeout on The Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life. From everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on.
Need a car? Need financing? Need somebody to cut through the red tape and send you rolling down the highway? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Got great credit and just prefer a quality pre-owned car at a fair price from somebody you can trust? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Want to avoid high pressure to feel appreciated and be able to choose from a wide selection of AutoCheck and Carfax certified vehicles? Prestige Auto Sales is the place to go. Prestige Auto Sales in Ocala and Bellevue. Prestige. It's all there in our name.
If you need a sign or a banner for your yard or your business or your campaign, I'd recommend you go to Signs Unlimited at 318 South Magnolia in Ocala. Screen printing, embroidery, digital graphics. Do what I did when we needed signs for the Save the Marion Theater Group. Go see Vic Buttermore at Signs Unlimited if you want quality work with a fast turnaround from somebody who is deeply committed to his community and always ready to assist you. There's a reason Vic's slogan is, it's our business to make your business better. Sign up for Signs Unlimited. Call 732-7341 today.
Getting a head start in learning to read is more important now than ever for our young children. The Reading Pals program of Marion County pairs up reading mentors with struggling kindergartners and helps them get up to speed in their most important years. But they need volunteers. If you'd like to be a Reading Pal, call Jan Hathaway at the United Way at 732-9696. That's 732-9696. Be a Reading Pal today.
Your home for CF Patriot basketball all season long. WOCA, The Source.
Beautiful Moments Party Rentals presents Showcase Under the Stars, a bridal affair to remember. This event has it all. Caterers, photographers, florists, DJs, venues, and more. All gathered in one place and all there to help you plan your special day. Brides, bring your bridesmaids and friends alike. This is the event you don't want to miss. There will be food, fun, trivia games, and prizes with different wedding-themed areas to explore. Tickets are only $10, and Beautiful Moments Party Rentals is donating 100% to the United Way of Marion County. Advance tickets can be purchased at Beautiful Moments Party Rentals, 3400 Southwest 60th Avenue in Ocala. Showcase Under the Stars takes place on March 13th from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m., so make plans to be there. Again, that's March 13th at Beautiful Moments Party Rentals from 5 to 9 p.m. If you have any questions, just give them a call. 307-8180. That's 307-8180. And make your plans to attend the Showcase Under the Stars. Showcase Under the Stars.
Veterans are the foundation upon which our freedom is built. Listen to The Source, WOCA, each Thursday at 9 a.m. to Veterans News with Hank Whittier from Vets Helping Vets. You'll hear tributes, information on veterans' issues, and stories that will make you laugh, cry, and feel proud. Veterans News always focuses on the military, past and present, and on our first responders. Veterans News is brought to you each week by Palm Chevrolet, where supporting the community is the Palm Chevy way, and by Bob Wine's Camellia Gardens and Nursery, keeping you blooming since 1952.
Hey, you guys, this is Lou, and if you don't want to be a dirty little bite sitting on a curb eating dirty white wines, you better head on down to Dairy Queen Silver Springs. They got the best, the juiciest, tastiest char-grilled hot dogs, burgers, solid filet of fish and chicken, and 90% fat-free pulled pork barbecue that's a little sweet and a little spicy. You know, Dairy Queen doesn't use processed and formed junk like the competition, so come on down to Dairy Queen Silver Springs, home of the real five-buck lunch.
News Talk 1370, WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370, WOCA. You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
A new study found the use of whole genome sequencing, or WGS, did an incomplete job of identifying inherited diseases. Call him the comedian-in-chief. President Obama appeared in an internet series answering questions for Between the Ferns, a series hosted by Zach Galifianakis. But it was for a serious cause. The White House says it's gotten young people to sign up for health insurance. A lot of people were at a loss for words, or at least for 140 characters today, while Twitter went down for a while. The microblogging site will only say that it was due to maintenance and it's back up. Do I need to go to the Department of Motor Vehicles if I don't even drive my car? California's DMV is hearing ideas today on how to integrate driverless cars onto public roads. Questions range from data privacy and security to whether somebody has to be in the driver's seat at all. ABC News.
Do you know what that sound is? That's your new digital marketing department. And that'll be your new web designer. And that's Haibu, where these experts are joined by many more, from web designers to search marketing specialists, who work hard to get your business noticed online and on mobile. Best of all, Haibu can do it all for you, or give you the tools to do it yourself. To find out more, go to Haibu.com, that's Haibu.com, or call 877-938-HAIBU. Oh, that'll be your next new customer. Haibu, made for business.
I'm standing on a ledge high in the Blue Ridge Mountains. I swear I can see forever. Green in the spring, dazzling colors come fall. Part of why I'm here is to preserve this. I am 1 mile of CSX railroad track. There are 21,000 more like me. Together, we help trains move a ton of freight nearly 450 miles on 1 gallon of fuel. Tomorrow is full of promise. Let's keep it that way. CSX. How tomorrow...
I'm a shot. 30 seconds. I'm on right now. I don't believe you.
Okay, okay. Enough kidding around.
Ho, 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 ho. Ho, ho, ho.
And now it's time for the
Buddy Martin Sports Page.
He actually had me stay here last night in his gym.
Like I don't fit in. Like I don't belong here.
Let's go talk to a couple of guys that never gamble.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. See, Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put you on the poor house at the same time. He didn't think we could do it.
Gambling is illegal at Bushwood, sir, and I never slice.
And now,
here's Buddy.
Yeah.
care about that. What you care about is a Tuesday. That means it's time for our gang to go around the water cooler, where we have a lot of conversation. You should be in here sometimes during the break. Some of the things we say that are not on the air, quite often more interesting than what's on the air, than Austin is smiling when I said that. If they only knew, Austin, if they only knew. Today we'll have our go-long segments. It's time for Major Hoop now, and we're getting on with the SEC. The Gators will play Friday at 1 o'clock, winner of the Texas A&M and Missouri game. And we'll be talking about that coming up next, about my blog on why people love this team. Billy Donovan speaking out once again about the fact that teams that play conference title games on Sunday, Selection Sunday, shouldn't have to play so early in the week during the NCAAs. So we'll talk about that a little bit. The brackets. This will be a good topic for discussion around the water cooler. Is Warren Buffett just crazy or what? $1 billion for a perfect – I mean, I know it's remote, but $1 billion? That's crazy.
Think,
man,
about all the Yahoo brackets that are going to be filled out.
Oh, my God. Well, of course, you're going to get one per customer. So
you're filling one out, aren't you?
Of course, for a billion.
For $1 billion.
I mean, if you buy a lottery ticket, why wouldn't you take a free shot?
Last night, this conversation came up last night at dinner, and the people I was with, my girlfriend included, said, I don't know anything about college basketball, but I'm just going to take it. I'm going to do it anyway. It's $1 billion.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's like it's the old mentality when I tell you about the lottery, lotto. Remember I said to you, people say, boy, it's $20 billion. I'm going to play tonight. Like, that gives them a better chance.
Yeah.
You know? What difference? If you won't take two.
It
million,
actually gives you a worse chance.
Because you've got more people playing.
Right.
So I never got that, oh, boy, this thing's way up now. I'm going to play it tonight.
But if you finish in the top 20, if you're the top 20 people, you win $100,000.
Yeah, but that's hard to do, too.
I mean, it is.
I can tell you the time. Last 10 times, I probably played the lottery 3 times a year. The last 15 times I played, if I got one number, I was doing good. Crazy. Anyway.
Aren't the odds against you, though, if you're Warren Buffett? Eventually, somebody's going to get a perfect bracket. Obviously, there's a chance for one bracket.
We'll get into that during the wine and water, because that's the whole topic is about what do you do. Rick Riley wrote a really good column on this. He went to Omaha and interviewed Warren Buffett. He talks about the odds of a lot of things. He talks about Buffett and what's going to happen if somebody gets, you know, that final week and those four teams are in there, you know, what's going to happen. It's pretty interesting. So we'll talk about that a little bit and visit. And I haven't looked at the wire, but there's got to be some free agency news going on. It's 4 o'clock today. It started the National Football League. So let's go right to the news and talk about who's signing whom. There were some good free agents out there. What you got, Austin?
Well, the Cleveland Browns reached agreements with former Cardinals linebacker Carlos Dansby and former 49ers safety Dante Whitner. Dansby agreed to a 4-year, $24 million deal that includes $14 million guaranteed, and Whitner reached agreement on a 4-year, $28 million deal. Another free agency headline. DeMarcus Ware no longer a Dallas Cowboy. The Cowboys released their all-time leader in sacks, saving $7.4 million against the salary cap. Ware put up 117 sacks in 9 seasons with the Cowboys, earning Pro Bowl honors every year from 06 to 12. But he had a career low 6 sacks in 2013 and missed the first 3 games with a quadriceps strain. A little NBA news. Andrew Bynum will play in his first NBA game in 3 months. When he makes his debut with the Pacers tonight against the Celtics, Bynum was traded from Cleveland to Chicago on January 7th, but then was cut the next day by Chicago, eventually signed with Indiana in early February.
Honestly, I forgot even that Andrew Bynum played basketball.
Yeah, he's been shipped around everywhere. Hasn't really done anything since he's been in the league. Final headline, I don't know if you saw this, buddy. Dallas Stars, obviously talking about hockey,
scary,
forward
man.
Rich Peverly skated to the bench early in the first period last night and collapsed on the bench.
Did you see it?
I wasn't watching it live. I saw the
replay.
Yeah, kind of just all the players.
Talking about panic. They were really panicking.
There. Yeah, it was a scary situation for obviously everybody involved.
Well, he's got heart problems.
His heart stopped.
Well, he missed a game last week for an irregular heartbeat. So they knew he had heart issues.
They were throwing things on the court to stop play.
On the ice.
On the ice, yeah.
They were the Japanese sport coach and hockey stick.
And then they suspended the game.
Yeah, they decided.
As they should have.
And today he's undergoing tests at a hospital to examine what exactly caused the event. So Very scary event.
I love the story, Deb. When he was in a, his heart stopped, and he got a defibrillator on him and got it going again. Put him in the ambulance, taking him off. He woke up and said, "Can I go back in?"
Yeah.
If that's not a hockey player, you know, that's typical hockey player's mentality. So, yeah, that was a very scary moment on TV yesterday. I didn't watch it live, but I saw it just after it happened.
Right. And all the you could tell that all the Dallas Star players saw it, knew what happened. Everybody just kind of gravitated toward him.
Yeah. All right. Anything else on the way? Nobody know the major. What happened to Julius Peppers and all those guys that were going there looking at? There's quite a few good looking players that were still in free agency. Well, I guess they're probably dealing right now. So.
Yeah, there's a bunch of different ones.
Let's
one
pull up that list at some point.
Darrell Revis is going to get cut by the Bucks, so they don't have to pay him.
Yeah.
$16 million.
Well, look, you know who's looking at him? New England.
And the Jets looking at him back again.
Yeah, well, that's because the New England's looking at him.
Right, but Revis is getting, you know, they're going to cut him that free $16 million of their cap. You know who's got the most cap room of any team in the NFL?
So I heard this the other day.
The Oakland Raiders.
Yeah, I was going to say the Browns or the Raiders probably.
And is there a team that you have less confidence in than the Raiders than to do what they need to do with that money?
Well, here's the thing about this franchise. This franchise used to have all kind of mottos, just win, baby, you know, about winning and excellence and all this stuff. And Al Davis made a big thing out of this being excellence. And they had a tremendous record at one point. He wanted to say they were probably who was the hockey team? Montreal had the all-time record for wins and championships, whatever. He called themselves the Canadians of the National Football League. And for a while, they had a phenomenal record. About 1980s, they started tanking, man. And
when Alzheimer's set in with Al Davis.
Well, and also they lost that Super Bowl game to Tampa. That was the end of it all. And, well, they just went right down the drain.
Well, that was that. They lost that Super Bowl to Tampa, though, in the 2000s.
Well, they were already going. They just pushed them over the edge.
Right.
And Gruden leaving, of course, at the time. I have a friend who worked for the Raiders. And I said, "Well, you got a good coach in Gruden." He says, "No, we're glad to see him go. We'd like to see him get out." I said, "Why?" He didn't like him. Maybe that's why they're the way they are now, because guys like Gruden didn't stay. So, anyway, all right. Tom James texts he's on his way in. We'll talk about free agency. Dave Pingelor should be, hopefully, I forgot to text Dave. I hope he'll be there, so we'll find out. We'll take a break, come back for more on after this timeout on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3
come on, we got
FM. If you'd like to join in on the conversation, you can do so by texting us 352-507-5352 right here at The Source.
Since 1976, Daniel L. Hightower, a lawyer, has been fighting for accident victim justice in North Central Florida and statewide. He believes everyone in America should follow the rules, including the insurance companies. He and his firm have experience fighting for victims of personal injury, wrongful death, workers' compensation, and Social Security disability, as well as serving those in need of help with bankruptcy, simple wills, and estate plans. The mission at the law offices of Daniel L. Hightower, PA, is to represent deserving clients and recover the maximum benefits they are entitled to by law in a timely manner. In personal injury and workers' compensation cases, there are no fees or costs unless a recovery is made. The law office of Daniel L. Hightower is located at 7 East Silver Springs Boulevard, Suite 300. For your free consultation, call 352-629-7777 or 1-888-LAW-1976 and visit danhightower.com for more information. Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice, and the proud sponsor of Ask the Cops.
Hi, this is Tom Schmitz, the host of the Saturday Sports Page on WOCA. The Saturday Sports Page is your weekend destination for everything sports, from NASCAR to golf, baseball to boxing, and of course, the best, most comprehensive football coverage on the radio. Also, you don't want to miss my weekly Are You Kidding Me rant? So join me, Austin Tatman, and Josh LaSalva every Saturday morning at 10 a.m. for the Saturday Sports Page on WOCA, The Source.
Whenever something big happens in Ocala and Marion County, Buddy Martin is there on the case.
John Gruden, ESPN Monday Night Football, today spoke to the group here at the Gateway Bank. I'm going to play a little game of just word association with you. One, Ocala.
Ocala, this is a great community. It's a great group of people.
John Gruden coaching again.
One of these days I'll be back.
So remember, always check out Buddy Martin on the Voice of Ocala on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
You know what that anticipation feels like when you're about to open a gift? InnaBox offers personalized gifts, everything you'll need for that special occasion. InnaBox. Holidays, birthdays, graduations, spa days, weddings, anniversaries, get wells, and more. InnaBox. Visit InnaBoxCelebrations.com and pick your theme. There's even a corporate option. InnaBox creates the magic, and you'll be the rock star. Visit InnaBoxCelebrations.com, partnered with Woodley Gardens.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to pet expert Charlotte Reed and veterinarian Dr. Michael C. Fleck. They're calling in live from the Global Pet Expo at the Orange County Convention Center in Orlando.
News Bites, the hottest news and current events are bite-sized.
And then Mark E. Becker will be with us. He's an attorney and he wants to talk about why more and more people are not using the legal system and are going outside the law to resolve their issues.
Stay tuned for a new quarterly show called Higher Education Happenings with Mike Fallon, Dr. Jennifer Friend, Crystal Flynn and Katie Degner, speaking about current higher education topics that impact Marion County students, parents, and the local economy.
And then tune in to Legally Yours. John Fuller is the host of that show. He's an attorney from here in Ocala, and he'll answer your legal questions.
Brandy Cooney and Julie Whitaker is from the Childhood Development Services. They'll be speaking about their fundraising event happening this Saturday, the tour around the world.
All of that plus Fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live, right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Phoenix Promotional Solutions, your company supplier of banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Where you give them approved artwork by noon, the next day by 4 p.m., you pick up your banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404. That's 368-2404. Don't forget, they do vehicle wraps also. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that.
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new truck.
Yep, we can even do that too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
All day I face barren waste without the taste of water.
Man, that song makes me thirsty. Oh, it must be time for that segment, Around the Water Cooler with Buddy and Tom-Tom. Tom-Tom? Wait, Buddy and Tom and Tom. Oh, who cares? Here's Around the Water Cooler.
The nights are cool and I'm a fool. Each star's a pool of water. Cool water. But with the dawn I'll wake and yawn and carry on to water.
Everybody.
Come on, Schmitty.
Come on. All together. Let's
you've got it in you. I know it.
Water. Come on, Tom. Yeah, are we together here or what? Let's, come on.
Shots of vodka.
Water.
Okay, yeah, I need a drink now.
Okay. You know,
not of water.
By the way, we have a major sponsor looking at us on this right now. You know what?
Well, he's going to say change the song.
You will learn to sing.
He's going
to
say change
water, which is part of the deal. Just
I know how smart this sponsor is, and they're going to say change the song.
They already told me they want it on. They want it on. So you'll either sing it now or you won't get to participate.
I'm going to have to take a meeting
That's a deal breaker.
I'm going to have to take a meeting with this guy and see if we can get that changed.
Meeting, all right. That ain't going to happen. So anyway, it's time for Around the Water Cooler. How you doing, TJ?
Gentlemen, good. A little sad today. It's my
Louisville has been banned from playing in the tournament.
Louisville's actually up in the top five, but last year's Cinderellas from the tournament, Florida Gulf Coast,
have been eliminated.
Not going to be there. They were close on Sunday, but didn't quite make it back. Mercer in the ASUN title game. Led by 18 early. FGCU came all the way back, cut it to 1 in the second half, and ran out of gas.
I see Manhattan made it in, too.
They did. They beat Iona, I believe.
Now, who won the Western Carolina game in the SoCo?
Man, you're really going to test
nobody really cares.
I know I saw the highlights last night, and it was Western Carolina and what, Wofford?
Wofford, yeah. I know who wasn't in it. I think they won 11 games this year. Oh, they're terrible.
Wofford won 56-53.
There you go.
Thank you. All right,
it's hoop time. It's hoop time, and we got to get into the brackets. and have a serious discussion about brackets.
Well, yeah, Final Four's got Carolina in it. We know that.
Yeah. So, I know. Everything Carolina and this Georgia Southern.
Just, Carolina.
Just, you know, once you just put, you should put down every bracket, Carolina and Georgia Southern.
All of course. That's your Sweet 16 matchup there.
Exactly.
I got to play four teams twice.
11-win Georgia Southern team.
So, he's in this mood. He wants to be a notice, so that's why he's aggravating. But anyway, let's talk about a second for let's talk about Buffett's decision to pay $1 billion for anybody who gets a perfect bracket. But before we do that, I know you have this fascination. You're like, can't sleep at night, worry about this Malaysian plane.
Love
this
story.
What is going on with you, man?
Love this story. It's just absolutely fascinating me. So I think it landed somewhere. Come on.
Yeah, what's your theory on it?
That it landed somewhere.
I mean, so you think
no wreckage, no.
Believes we have a real life lost going on.
Absolutely, I thought about that. No wreckage, no debris.
I saw this
that
movie.
Equals no crash, no terrorism. They're sitting on an island chilling somewhere.
I'm a like, 3 hour tour.
I think you might be onto something there with another lost, because it is a weird deal. And you know, if it was underwater, they hear the pings or something.
Right.
And you know, we've all read the story, and it's interesting. It's not a sports topic, but it does capture your imagination. And you think about the Payne Stewart plane, the ghost plane, things like that. You think about the Bermuda Triangle, which has had the intrigue of our players' planes fly in, don't come out. You think about the two Iranians, where they're saying now the two Iranians who had these illegal passports, and that one source is saying that they were trying to escape from Iran, these two people with fake passports. The fake passport is really the red herring here, the whole thing. What is going on with that?
You know? Well, and it's one of those situations like your favorite TV shows where they're actually looking in the wrong place, and that's what they've been doing now the last 3 days. We realize they've been looking way in the other direction where they should be looking. So it's got every bit of intrigue that you could ever want.
All right, so here are the odds. Austin, make these odds for me. What's your grader? Which would you think you'd be able to do? Would you rather try to do? Find the lost Malaysian plane or have a perfect bracket?
Well, if it's on Yahoo, get the perfect bracket.
All right. I think Dave Pingler wants us to call you back, but we'll do that. All right, so Tom Schmitz, which would you rather try to do? If you had to do one of the two tasks, try to get the perfect bracket or find the Malaysian plane?
Oh, I'm finding the Malaysian plane. The Chinese government will give me so much more money than Warren Buffett.
That's $1 billion. What's the price tag? I mean, if
it's
Chinese government, if they give me ownership of like 45 feet of the Great Wall of China, I'm in.
Why don't you just do it for mankind?
Oh, no, there's got to be some cash value for me. I mean, it's me. I'm not the guy you are. I got to have some cash out of the deal.
Yeah, if all things were equal, though, Schmitty, you know, $1 billion for either victory there, which one would it be, you know?
A billion? Oh, I'd want the bragging rights of the bracket perfect.
I think I'm with you on that one, actually.
It's easy to say this, so it sounds ridiculous. I'd give the billion to get those lives back.
That is the honorable answer.
I know it's easy to say if you don't have to do it, but I really believe I would give, if they could give me a choice,
sure,
and I could give the big end over and say, bring the people back, I'd do it. Anyway, what would be you rather try to do? Do the perfect bracket, or you're a basketball man?
I'm a basketball guy. I've never even gotten a perfect Final Four. I've gotten three out of four times.
Yeah.
I've gotten three out of four. I've had friends that have gotten four out of four, but as far as the perfect bracket, meaning every game of every round, I think it happens a couple of times every year. Somebody does
no,
it.
No.
Mm-mm. No?
Mm-mm. That's why Warren Buffett did it. Since ESPN and Yahoo have been doing this, there's never been a perfect bracket.
Oh, so there's never been one?
Never been a perfect bracket.
In their annual contest.
Okay.
There's been people that have missed one.
Or people could have claimed they had one, but no documentation.
But ESPN and Yahoo, since they've been doing it online, there's been people that have missed one game, but nobody's missed no game.
So far, the only one I know about is one I did a couple years ago. That's the one I know about.
You forgot to turn it in.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah.
It wasn't the bracket of integrity.
It was that $20 office pool, and he forgot to turn it in.
I don't know, buddy. I actually like what you said, though, about giving the money to save the lives in Malaysia.
Pay it forward.
You know what? There's no Brinks truck following no hearse.
Nope. Pay it forward.
It's interesting. Rick Riley's column is quite interesting, and he talks about this, this whole phenomenon. And what would you do if you got down to Sunday and there was a perfect Final Four and $1 billion? And he asked him about – he asked Buffett about – you know, how this thing works, and according to what he said, there's going to be one entry per person. Quicken and Berkshire are the two sponsors. Okay. And he says nobody from there can play. Obviously, no cheating. And he goes through a lot of different odds on this, like the odds of you becoming president, 10 million to one, by the way, Riley says, 10 million to one. And then odds of your identity being stolen, 33 to one, et cetera, et cetera. But what you wonder about is that much money, could you fix some games, right? Think about it. I mean, what if you were getting down? All right, let's say you had – you were down to the final – let's say you had this Elite Eight, and you had 7 out of 8 in that game, and you knew you had a really good shot of getting a billion on this deal, and you could get your hands on $200,000.
Yeah.
You know, and you say to the shady guy in the corner, Tom's friends, said, "Hey, go make a little visit and see if you can't give him some walking around money for a little favor here or there." You know, go
that's an investment that gives you quite a return, isn't it?
I mean, think about it for a second. It'd make a great play or movie, wouldn't it?
Sure.
You're gonna get the billion if one team loses, and what do you do? What do you think, Tom? Would happen?
I know a guy that knows a guy.
What kind of conspiracy would that cause, or what kind of uproar would that cause? That
don't even want to go there.
A fixed Final Four because of a Warren bracket.
Think about this. It wouldn't be that hard. It wouldn't be that hard to do either. You say you win a billion. You invest $250 million into the fixing of the bracket. $250 million, it gets you a lot of games fixed.
It's the craziest thing about that is of all the guys in this room right now, the Buddy's one who the one brought that up is Buddy.
Well, that's no, because
the
Rick,
last guy
no,
you
because
think.
Rick Riley brought it up,
okay.
Who was one of the first guys you would think would bring that up.
Well, first, Buffett's response was talking about the whole bracket. Nobody can fix 63 games. That's true, but someone could fix one of those 63 if they had to. He said that the two big risks in this, he says, are one, somebody could do it, obviously, it's possible. And two, somebody tries to screw us. And like, how? Is somebody hacking to the system and changing a bracket after the game? Yeah, if they could hack into it. But that's the only just things that he sees that could possibly. Could that call
so if, think, Edward, hack in. If Edward Snowden somehow wins the $1 billion, then we'll know how.
Interesting. So, you got your bracket filled out yet, Tom? Tom?
We don't have a bracket yet.
No, but in your mind, you know your ones are going
to
be.
You picked your Final Four last week, didn't you?
Yeah,
you
did.
Yeah, but that was just something to do. Sunday night, I'll spend 4 hours after the show on the internet and reading and everything about teams that I don't know much about to come up with a bracket.
It's the best, isn't it?
I put so much work into it every year. And do absolutely horrible every year.
We've had one the last couple of years. We had one at the other station, and we had all the brackets that we had, and there weren't even any good scores. And a lot of the people who did well, and I hate to say this, sounds sexist.
Well, women.
Women who had no idea what they were
okay,
doing.
Okay, and I tried that theory. You know how they pick based on the colors of the mascot, okay? I had what I thought was the coolest mascot last year, the Jackrabbits of South Dakota State going to the Sweet 16. Yeah, out in the first round.
Well, you're not a woman, so you don't have a woman's perspective.
Exactly.
But they think it's cool.
I think we should do an experiment. Either get an animal or a first grader to pick fill out a bracket this year and see how they do.
Okay.
Let's pick against them.
All right.
And I guarantee you they'll beat us.
I let my boxer Rottweiler mix pick the bracket.
Okay. My puppy Kiki will fill out a bracket and get a check from Warren Buffett, I'm sure.
All right, so you get a chance here in the show. You probably didn't yesterday, right?
Not yesterday.
We had the great Dan Jenkins on yesterday.
Yes.
And we thoroughly enjoyed the conversation. By the way, Dave Pingler will join us in about 2 or 3 minutes here, and we'll get his take. Really, really interesting. We had a bite. We're going to hear the bite from Dan Jenkins from yesterday. And this is, which one was this you picked, Austin?
This was the reasons why he chose to write the book.
Okay, here you go. Dan Jenkins.
Well, I wanted to talk mostly about journalism, buddy. And I put you know, Ben Hogan is the only person that has two chapters in this book, because I felt that was necessary, because I knew the greatest golfer in the world and covered him and had the good fortune to come from the same town. So I felt like I needed to put that in there. The rest of the stuff, the hardest part was to keep myself out. And then I realized one day, well, hell, this is about me. I can't keep everything out.
Exactly.
So, but I told a lot of, you know, mostly journalism stories, as you may have noticed, and I quoted a lot of my people I think are good writers and people who influenced me and stuff like that. But I feel a little embarrassed that I probably put too much of the stuff in there that I've written, but who knows.
And you know, the one thing about this, as he calls it, semi-memoir he wrote, that those of us who really begged Dan to write it a long time ago, and I did, started 15 years ago asking, you got to write this. He didn't want to put himself in the book that much. That's just kind of how he is. But it's a good laugh. It's a good book. It's called Dan Jenkins, Semi-Memoirs. His Own Self. So pick it up. The bookstore. I got it. I read it. I loved it. All right. Take a break. Come back. We'll get Dave Pinglore around the water cooler next. Maybe he'll sing Cool Water coming up next on Buddy's Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA.
The Source.
You know, Austin, I'm sitting here at the computer looking at our Facebook page, and boy, we really need to tell more listeners about our Facebook page.
No, Tom, see, you got it all wrong. Twitter is the new age.
What's a tweeter?
No, a Twitter, Tom. The Voice of Ocala has a Twitter.
We do? Well, how do we tell our listeners about that?
All they have to do is get the Twitter app or go to twitter.com, type in Voice of Ocala in the search box, and click follow.
All right, well, what's the tweeter do?
The Voice of Ocala's Twitter page updates all of its followers on the latest news, guests, giveaways, and contests.
Oh, okay. But couldn't listeners just tune in weekdays from 3 to 6 to 1370 AM and 96.3 FM, or even go to online at WOCA.com? Wouldn't that be easier?
Yeah, okay, maybe.
Here in Florida, when you're looking to go to the beach, you've got hundreds of options. Theme parks, no shortage of options there either. But when it comes to home insurance, most companies have only one option. Allstate is different. Here in Florida, Allstate agents offer home insurance options from several companies, so they can help you get the coverage that's right for you. And they'll help you save on quality car insurance, too. For starters, safe drivers save 45% with Allstate. So before you settle for just one option, talk to someone with many home and car insurance options. Your local Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
For more information, call the McDonald Agency at 352-622-2333 or visit us online at themcdonaldagency.com.
Allstate has no financial responsibility to you for any home insurance policy you purchase and would not be responsible for any claims. Allstate does not make any representations or accept liability related to operations of home insurance companies, including but not limited to their financial conditions. Subject to terms, conditions, and availability. Savings vary.
Lance.
Yes, George.
Your cousin Myrtle wants to watch TV.
So?
She wants to watch TV in our living room.
So?
Well, she needs your chair.
Go get her chair.
But it's in Devon Self Storage and she wrapped it well with the supplies and it's 8 o'clock at night.
So? Devon Self Storage is open late and you have your passcode and you know where they are across from Hobby Lobby.
But Alice!
You can call them tomorrow at 873-0777 and thank them for being open late.
But Alice, I just got my warm jammies.
George.
I'll be back with a chair from Devon Self Storage.
Thanks, George. Thanks.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
People who do the most texting at night have the worst sleep. Because each time we send a text, a part of our brain goes on high alert because we're waiting for a response. Frequent use of artificial sweeteners has been shown to increase hunger and to lead to weight gain. Couples who laugh together are the happiest because laughter makes us secrete feel-good endorphins. So laughter usually means long-term love.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Life jackets save lives. Where in Florida? Mostly sunny today and pleasantly warm. The high 79 on the coast, 85 inland. Increasing clouds tonight, low 60 to 64. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy and becoming breezy. With a couple of showers and a thunderstorm around, the high 80 to 84. Thursday, some clouds giving way to sunshine. Noticeably cooler, high 62 to 66. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Hi, this is Joe from Damage Control Services. Join me Tuesdays at 10:30 when we discuss what to do when your property gets damaged, how to fix it fast, and get back on track. At Damage Control, we specialize in helping home and business owners recover from damage caused by floods, fires, storms, tree damage, mold, and all other insurance-related disasters. So when disaster strikes, big or small, call Damage Control Services. Call me, 352-817-6574.
352-507-5352.
352-507-5352.
352-507-5352.
Tom!
352-507-5352.
Tom!
Whoa, what?
What is that phone number?
Oh, that's our new number for the Voice of Ocala text line. 352-507-5352. If you want to reach Buddy, me, or any of y'all via text. So all you got to do is text 352-507-5352 anytime.
1370 WOCA.
Time now to go to the hotline, down to the hottest guy in Orlando, the guy who talks to mailboxes, makes crazy predictions, and looks very spiffy. Where do you get your clothes from, Dave Pingelore?
Oh, God. Great question.
All over, huh?
All over.
Do you think
custom suits?
Yeah,
Suits, custom shirts. You know, you get. It's all about the part.
Okay, I'm gonna just say something nice about you. I'm not gonna say anything nice for a couple months. Okay, but this is. I like the way you're looking. I also like the fact that how you bring your guys in there. You know, Tom and the whole gang and whatever. And just but today we're gonna do that today on our show for a couple minutes with you. So we're all kind of gonna jump in and talk about, first of all, the Gators and his basketball team. I mean, I wrote a column over the last weekend saying, this is why we love these guys. We love this Florida basketball team. You agree with that?
Oh, yeah, fun to watch. You know, got a lot of seniors on the team. Well coached, well disciplined. I mean, if they have a hiccup, it's going to be a bad hiccup because they look like the team to be destined for at least the Final Four appearance. But it's the NCAA tournament. It's all about matchups. But they're playing some good basketball. Even when Kentucky the other day kind of made a little run there in the second half. Gators answered, pulled away late, and boom, no problem. They're like, it's very workmanlike for them.
You're going to get them. You're going to get them right. A week from Friday, so that'll be, or whatever day they play down there.
They will be in Orlando. There'll be Thursday games here.
Thursday game. Okay.
Thursday, Saturday. All right.
Does everybody agree with me on this, that it feels like this Florida team, while it's a major university, it has a mid-major makeup to how the team is, not meaning in talent, but the way, you know, VCU and George Mason all made their deep runs with senior-laden programs, something you don't see a lot of the big schools doing anymore because kids are leaving after junior year and all. It has kind of that mid-major feel to it.
Well, it does, and it only does because they don't really have that NBA guy. They don't have Anthony Davis when he was at Kentucky. They don't have that premier player. They just have a lot of above average guys like seniors. So teams that go into the tournament that are loaded with seniors, like you mentioned in the past, they make a run. I mean, that's a great way to, you know, if your people get ready to do their brackets and do some homework, you go look at teams that have been together for a number of years, and those are the teams that really make a little bit of a mark going through the tournament. So for the Gators' sake, that's what they have. I mean, there's guys on there that they might get a sniff at the NBA, but, you know, they're not going to be anything dominant in the NBA. You know, there's going to be guys. You know, you look at a Patrick Young who wanted to come out last year. I mean, if Patrick Young went into the NBA last year, he'd just be just some guy.
Dave, it's Tom James. If Florida can go all the way and win the national championship, that'll be three national championships for Gator basketball, which will equal – how many national championships Gator football has historically. Will Florida then be officially a basketball school?
Well, I don't think they'll ever be officially. I mean, what is that? What does that really mean? I mean, officially, there'll always be, you know, people will think of the Florida Gators as a football school, no matter what. I mean, Billy Donovan, you know, he's one of the great college basketball coaches in his era, and he still probably doesn't get the notability and get recognized as he should if he was doing this at Kentucky because, officially Kentucky's more of a basketball school. So I think if the guy won six national championships, it would still be under the, you know, it wouldn't be considered a basketball school. But it, but from a sports fan's perspective, I mean, why not? I mean, year in and year out, he's better than the football program.
What does that say about the University of Florida's program? I dare, there's not very many programs that can say if they win this year, they got more than one national championship in both programs. And he's got, this school will have three in both programs if they win.
Well, yeah, you could. Well, yeah, because most of the time a quote unquote basketball school is winning it, a national championship, and football is really second fiddle to, you know, if you go back and look at the history of who won national championships, you know, if you look at Kansas and, you know, other schools like that, they're not predominantly football. So, yeah, I mean, it's impressive. I mean, it's, and Donovan is, again, buddy, I tell you this every week. You listen to his press conference on Monday. The guy's a smart guy. He knows what he's saying. He knows how to get kids to buy in. And just from following him and over the last couple of years, getting to the Elite Eight games, guys, you just hope, you know, they can win it all. I mean, if there's ever a coach deserving of winning it this year, it would be him.
I think he's done his best coaching job so far, and this could be his best coaching job, but depending on what happens to the team. Final question for Dave Bigler, Local 6. We're talking about this missing plane, Malaysian airliner, which everybody's talking about. Then we're talking about the perfect bracket. If you pick it with Warren Buffett, you get $1 billion, right? So
right.
If you had to take one task on and you had to do one of the two, which one would you have the best chance at?
Of finding the plane?
Finding the plane or picking a perfect bracket?
That's a good question. I mean, well, finding the plane is more than one person looking for it.
Yeah.
Picking your bracket is really yourself.
Well, you got to be the one that finds the plane, though.
You're the only one.
Yeah, you're the one who finds it.
I probably have a better shot at picking every game.
Well, get out your brackets.
I don't understand how they lost the plane. That's just mind-boggling.
I know. It's just mind-boggling. It's also mind-boggling. They can make big 63 games. So we'll get your brackets next week after selecting Sunday on, I think it's on your station, isn't it, on Sunday?
Sunday night, Local yeah. 6, your home yeah. of the yeah. NCAA tournament.
So nice little plug in there. All right, anything on Local 6 tonight we should look for besides the mailbox?
Breaking news happening here. Blaine Gabbert just traded to the San Francisco 49ers
okay.
for a six-round selection.
Okay.
So, you know, the Jags are certainly going to be looking for a quarterback, and if Houston doesn't take Blake Bortles, the Jags just might take Blake Bortles.
And this just in, Steve Spurrier has agreed to a five-year contract to come back to the University of Florida. Just kidding.
Would
that be a good one?
That'd
be good. Go with it.
All right,
thanks, sir. Thank you, David. Dave Bingle from Local 6. He has fun. I think this thing about it is that when look, how much news can you give anymore?
Right.
You can't. It's been on the ESPN.
He has a good time.
You did it, Tom. You did it, TV news for 3 years, was it? Was it?
About that 8-9 years,
but in Fort Lauderdale. I mean, you did it several places, but
in Southwest Florida, about five
years.
That long?
Yeah. Okay, yeah. I turned on my TV one day, and there's Tom doing my local news on NBC on our NBC2, as they call it, right? Mm-hmm. And you know what it's like to sort of cobble things together and get things going. And what was it like for you? I mean, could you feel the shrinking need for local? I mean, it's not like
I was told that's what it was.
I know. Yeah. I remember that people were cutting. Some people were cutting it out completely.
You kind of what you have to do, and I don't know if it's still like that because I've been out of that world, the local news affiliate world for almost 10 years now. But you have to kind of create a little bit of a niche, and it's more than just given. 3-minute sports report every day. I used to do something called the Dream 18 where we'd focus on the 18 best golf holes in Southwest Florida every year.
By the way, you know who started that concept?
Would it be Buddy Martin? I don't know.
Dan Jenkins. The first Dream 18 in Sports Illustrated.
Wow.
He was the first one to ever do it.
Wasn't me, huh?
Yeah, and I did it in Denver, but I was a long time after Dan. Dan Jenkins started that idea.
Yeah.
Dream 18.
Yeah.
That's a great concept.
You've really got it, but you've got to kind of take yourself outside of the norm, outside of the box, and do those kinds of things.
Yeah, well, Schmitty was on in Statesboro for how many years?
That would be none.
Oh. By the way, just so you know, there's some guys on this program that have a little hardware. One guy won the Edward R. Murrow Broadcasting Award twice.
Twice.
Who would that be, Austin?
Austin, is that you?
Not me.
Is it Tom?
No, it is Tom.
Yeah.
Tom James.
Exactly, Tom James, two-time Edward R. Murrow Award winner.
you know, not to be outdone, somebody in this room also has an Emmy. That they won.
Yes.
Okay.
Emmy Lou Harris. It's an album.
We should have.
You should be sitting on this table.
We should have the Emmy in the window with the bobbleheads.
We're talking too much now. All right, let's go. Who wants to go long?
I'll go first.
All right, go ahead.
We're talking golf, so I'll go first. I'm putting my glasses on so I can actually see what I wrote. When you think of the top five golfers in the world, Roy McIlroy, Phil Mickelson, Graham McDowell, Luke Donald, Lee Westwood, and yes, even Tiger Woods are all names that come to mind. But according to Patrick Reed in his post-win interview after the WGC event this weekend, he's a top five golfer.
Not so much, but go ahead.
His resume is impressive.
That's awesome.
His resume is impressive. Two NCAA championships while at Augusta State. He has won three times on the PGA Tour in the last 7 months. In fact, he's joined a short list of first-name-only golfers, Tiger, Roy, Sergio, and Phil, as the only players to win three PGA Tour events, under, you know, at 23 years of age or younger. He's also the youngest player to ever win a WGC event. While you might not agree with Patrick Reed's statement about where he ranks, and I disagree with him as well, his bravado is refreshing on a tour that needs a little attitude right now. He may not be a top five yet, but his bravado to me is number one, and his pedigree is really good too.
I like
good job, and I agree with you. I like this guy. I think I like Patrick Reed. I think he's going to be a player. He's very cool. All right, you want to go along?
I got it. Gentlemen, I got a question for you. In which sport does home court slash home field advantage matter the most? Well, to some extent, it matters everywhere. Visiting players in baseball get doused in beer and popcorn. In the NFL, Seahawks fans these days are setting record decibel levels, while Mother Nature is at least as much of a 12th man in places like Green Bay and Buffalo and Chicago. Then there's European soccer, where it's not a stretch for visiting teams to fear for their lives. Same goes for Davis Cup tennis in some countries. Seriously, you don't believe me? Google 1987 Paraguay Davis Cup in your spare time. You'll see what I mean. But when it's all said and done, it's college sports that win the day with the backyard intimidation factor. While college football gets the edge in sheer numbers of people on hand to back a home team, I'll give the edge to college hoops for two simple reasons. Fan proximity to the court, and the benches, and the enclosed arenas. At Duke, the Cameron Crazies' outstretched fingertips dangle about 0.5 inches from the heads of the opposing players trying to inbound a pass. Ugly incidents this year may ultimately take fan access back a notch, but until it does, and even if it does, college hoops home cooking is second to none.
Very good. And by the way, I think college football is the biggest advantage home field.
But by the way,
we can talk about it.
By the way, Austin Tappman and Tom Schmitz, for all it's worth, agreed with Tom James 4 hours ago before we even knew you'd say college basketball.
Okay. Wow. All right. We say college football. Take a break. Come back. I'll give you mine. And Austin may have one if we got time to get in. Coming up next right here, I'll tell you why I love these Florida Gators, the basketball team. Coming up next right here on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA.
The Source.
Legally Yours, brought to you by Fuller & Fuller Attorneys at Law. On the air every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. with John Fuller, a board-certified civil trial lawyer for over 25 years. John welcomes your questions, from business to complex family matters to legal disputes. So tune in every Wednesday morning at 10:30 a.m. for Legally Yours with John Fuller, right here on WOCA 1370 a.m. and 96.3 FM, The Source.
Whether it's a car accident, storm damage, or a fire, when the unthinkable happens, it doesn't matter if you've saved money in 15 minutes. In this moment, it doesn't matter if your neighbor has the same insurance as you do. In this moment, what matters is that your independent insurance agent and the company that stands behind them have you covered. Auto Owners Insurance, the no problem people. Call George Mangan Insurance in Ocala today at 352-732-3191.
Hi, Danny Werfel here. You don't have to sacrifice convenience for local personal service.
At Florida Credit Union, you can transfer your high credit card balances to our rewards card and actually get paid with cash back. You'll enjoy low rates and a customizable card that fits your lifestyle for free.
Never tried a credit union? Maybe it's time for a new game plan.
The Florida Credit Union Wave Card.
connecting your money to your life.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
To water, cool water, clear water, water, keep open, then don't you listen.
All right, two go-longs, we call them, for our commentaries, and just one more comment about the home field before we go into my go-long about the Florida Gator basketball team. You can argue college basketball, college football. And I think your point was well taken about the closeness and the proximity, how close the fans are. And it may even be more the case now because it is getting to be more intimidating. You're right. It's just getting too crowded on the court. And we're seeing more and more cases of fan of players getting involved. We saw the fight with fans and things of that nature. So, but the advantage of the team, in my opinion, I mean, it's probably was more so in the day. But you weren't going to beat Bear Bryant in Tuscaloosa. You know, it just wasn't going to happen, you know. And it depends on what you're talking about.
Yeah.
They're really great teams. Now, you can go to, no offense, UCLA, you know, and beat the Trojans and the Coliseum. And not that difficult to do these days like it used to be when John McKay was there.
Mm-hmm.
I think it used to be more dominant. I think the Swamp, they've lost their home field there, you know. And losing that home field is a big deal because you've got to defend your home turf if you can't do anything. So I guess you could argue for both, but both of you had good commentaries, and I agree with Tom. I like Patrick Reed, what he said. I like
love the
fact
that – I don't think he's top five, but I like his attitude.
But you know what? He might be. And he's got to get. He's got to believe that. And a lot of guys believe it and don't say it. He believes it and he said it.
Yeah,
so,
but a golfer is not vanilla ice cream. That's refreshing.
He went to Augusta State and took them to two national championships in golf.
Yeah.
Augusta State's a school of about 3,300 kids in Augusta, Georgia.
Are you guys got a – I did not know that today, or do you know?
We do.
All right, we're going to go run through them quick. I'm going to give my commentary, and then we'll go to I did not know that. This is just a brief comment. This is from a blog I wrote regarding the Gators. This is not a real pretty team, if you know. The Florida Gators team. It's not in it at all like the teams in 06 and 07 that won national championships. And they had three, after all, they had three top 10 picks. But here's what I wrote. There's not much pretty about Scotty Wilbekin deking on his cat and mouse routine, darting in and pulling back almost like a semi-do-over, dumping a ball screen to Will Yeget, a guy who only shoots as a last resort. Yeget more than likely hands off to Casey Prather, who either drives to the hole or dishes to the mammoth Patrick Young. And sometimes on a hot night, Michael Frazier will be sweet-stroking threes like butter. The heart of their offense, however, is their defense and their zone trap. They turn over the opposing player and attack their will. They've come a long way since Donovan had to scour the parking lots for a quorum to hold practice. And even though it took his former team manager to fill the void and walk on Jacob Kurtz came aboard, he has wound up playing significant minutes. It is true, as the experts say, that success is 90% about showing up. And the firm of Wilbekin, Young, Prather, and Yet, the seniors, will all graduate magna cum laude from Donovan's School of Grit and Determination. These Gators always show up and play hard, period.
Amen.
Without a doubt.
Well, I like about it. All right, who wants to go? I did not know that.
I'll give you got one. Go ahead.
Yeah. Since January 1st, the Bulls have a plus 8.3 point differential with Joakim Noah on the court. Without him, negative 10.6.
Wow.
I did not know that. Do you hear what Joakim said last night, too? When asked about, do you like the MVP chance? He said, nope, our MVP is injured right now. I'm just a guy on the team.
Oh. Playing his best basketball of his career right now.
Yeah. LeBron James has failed to shoot a free throw in back-to-back games for just the second time in his career. The first time, he was still a rookie that referees didn't know should get the benefit of the doubt.
I did not know that. Tom?
Baseball. And it's got me thinking when Barry Bonds arrived at
back to
the
baseball.
Giants.
Yeah. 7 years away from the game.
Yeah.
You brought this up.
Giants spring training. Turning our attention to another guy of his similar ilk, Mark McGwire. his record-setting 70 home runs in the 1998 season. Traveled a total, and I don't know how they get this down to the exact feet, but traveled a total of 29,598 feet. That is enough to fly over Mount Everest.
Wow. I did not know that.
Okay, these Gators we talked about, it came from David Jones, USA Today. The Gators seniors have now scored a combined 3,241 points in their 4 years together. Wilpigan needs 158 to reach 1,000. Young is at 1216.
Wow. I did not know that. And all of them shooting 52% as a group of seniors.
All right, anybody got a, I know this for sure. I'll give you mine. This comes from fake ESPN.
Okay.
After inking his Nike contract, Manziel says signing one piece of paper for $20 million beats the heck out of signing 300 helmets for $7,000.
I know for certain that I have no shot at winning the $1 billion from Warren Buffett.
But we're going to try. That's the great sport of it.
Yeah, fill it out.
Everybody has to have a bracket, don't they?
Oh, yeah.
It's kind of un-American to have a bracket.
Now, how many sheets of integrity do you actually have?
But just one, Schmitty. Just one.
No, I turned the one into Yahoo, but I'll have like 113 on ESPN.
And you still won't get it.
And I know this for sure, and I say it with a tear in my eye, that Dunk City will not be part of the field.
You're having a little bit of a doubter about this. For those who don't know, Tom, of course, covers or calls the games on the internet for FGCU. Last year, made a season-ending TV piece called Dunk City. What? Going to call that?
Dunk City.
And it was very, very well done. And you followed the team and knew it was a great story last year. But you know, that's why it's called them great stories. You can't have them every year. But you had a great ride. So sad to see FGCU go, but you saw it at their best. So
yeah, still not getting used to this though.
Yeah. Good job on your go along today, guys. I want to thank our guest today, Angie Lewis, being the primary one. And of course, having the guys around the water cooler, Tom James, Tom Schmitz.
Dave
Pingalore, our special guest, and Austin Statman, A-Man, Tatman. I'm Buddy Martin. Have a wonderful night, everybody.
She grew up in an Indiana town, had a good-looking mom. She never was around, but she grew up tall and...
You know, Austin, I'm sitting here at the computer looking at our Facebook page, and boy, we really need to tell more listeners about our Facebook page.
No, Tom, see, you got it all wrong. Twitter is the new age.
What's a tweeter?
No, a Twitter, Tom. The Voice of Ocala has a Twitter.
We do? Well, how do we tell